play.
Well, got to be ready to play. Can't look at the records. This Missouri team, 8-8, 0-3 in the conference. Alabama rolling after its biggest win of the year against Mississippi State and Starkville. But this Missouri team is dangerous, as Coach Oates talked about. They do a lot of things well. Sean East is one of the best players in the SEC. But offensively, Alabama wants to be in attack mode, get to the free throw line. This is a Missouri team that has a lot of rim protection, top 10 in the country and block shots, but they do foul a lot. Alabama has had success getting to the rim, getting to the free throw line, and converting. The number one free throw shooting team in the SEC. Hopefully Alabama will be there a lot. And also some opportunities to get on the offensive glass. This is a Missouri team that doesn't defensive rebound as well as what we saw in Starkville on Saturday. So should be some second and maybe third chance opportunities for Alabama. Got to take advantage of those here tonight.
We do indeed, and we also take advantage on home games to recognize service members who are here. And our salute to service in the first half is presented by Royal Furniture, family-owned and operated for 75 years, with locations in Tuscaloosa, Birmingham, Memphis, and Jackson, Tennessee, for your shopping convenience. You can also shop online very conveniently at royalfurniture.com. The keys to victory and the starters when we come back to Tuscaloosa on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
1225 is your ultimate game day destination. Catch the game on one of their 35 big screen high def TVs, combined with an extensive menu of mouth-watering food and refreshing drinks. Juicy burgers, crispy wings, craft beers, signature cocktails. 1225, where the energy is high, the screens are massive, and the excitement is contagious. Visit 1225 on the Strip in Tuscaloosa, less than 2 blocks from Bryan Denny Stadium. 1225 Sports Bar, where sports, food, and fun collide.
Hey, Bama fans. Tuscaloosa Drug Company is a proud supporter of Crimson Tide Athletics. We've been serving our community and the University Athletic Department for over a decade. There are 3 locations in the Tuscaloosa and Northport area to serve you. We understand the importance of prompt and efficient service. That's why we strive to provide service that you can rely on, where we know you by name. The next time you have a medication need, call who the Tide calls. Tuscaloosa Drug.
Mario fue pintor más de 30 años. Cuando me dijo que se le estaban olvidando las cosas, fue difícil. Un día me dijo, me dijeron que pintara el marco del lado por dentro y pinté el lado de afuera.
Yo le di a la gente que le diga a su familia lo que está pasando con él.
Si algo se nota diferente, podría ser Alzheimer. Es momento de hablarlo. Visita alz.org/nuestras historias para saber más. Un mensaje de The Alzheimer's Association y The Ad Council.
Wouldn't it be great if life came with a remote control? You know, you could hit pause when you needed to, or hit rewind, like that time you knocked down that wasp's nest. Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. With early diagnosis and a few healthy changes, you can stop prediabetes before it leads to type 2 diabetes. To learn your risk, take the 1-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its prediabetes awareness partners.
When might you be buzzed? When you suddenly love everything.
You guys, I love this song.
I love these nachos.
I love our kickball league. Ugh! I love this guy.
What's your name?
You know what I'd love? A ride when it's time to head out.
If you see a buzzed warning sign, call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
I love your car. Is this real leather?
When you're high, you feel different. You think different, you talk different, you draw different, you listen to music different, but you probably knew that. Problem is, you also drive different, and not in a good way. That's why driving high is illegal everywhere. So if you're high, just don't drive. Make a plan to get a sober ride. Because if you feel different, you drive different. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Back at Colvin Coliseum, where we are about 10 minutes away from tipping it off. Crimson Tide and the counterparts from Columbia, Missouri. The Tigers coming to town for this matchup. And the keys to victory for Alabama are presented by Ford. Great things happen when you have a Ford F-150 truck. With impressive power and smart features, it's always a win with the F-150. Proud sponsor of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Bryan Passink, what are your keys for Alabama's victory here this evening?
Well, start slowing down Sean East, the guard, the veteran guard for Missouri. Averages 17 points a game, shoots 51% from the three-point line. He is their go-to guy. It'll be the focal point of this Alabama defense. But this Missouri team, as we talked about, they're dangerous. They're going to play fast. They're going to get up a lot of threes. One of the reasons they've struggled in SEC play is their inability to finish games and inability to knock down threes at a consistent rate. Alabama needs to defend the three-point line the way they have in recent games. Alabama's getting better on the defensive end. That's been the focus of Nate Oates and this staff really since early games in November. We've seen improvement. Want to see that improvement continue against a Missouri team that's got to have a little doubt in their mind. Starting off 0-3, playing against one of the hottest teams in the country. Alabama has reeled off several wins in a row against really good competition, coming off its best win of the year. So Alabama needs to start strong and come out with the right mindset like they did against Mississippi State. Alabama knew that that was going to be a tough fight against an NCAA tournament team in Mississippi State and Starkville. Need to have that same approach and mindset here tonight against a struggling Missouri team that is capable of getting it going.
We come back, we'll have the starting lineups presented by Walk-On Sports Bistro. You know, scratch-made dishes, wall-to-wall TVs, craft beers, and cocktails. Dig into mouth-watering menu items like po' boys, gumbo, and voodoo shrimp, plus fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads. Find your nearest location or order online or in the app. Walk-On Sports Bistro for the win. This has been our Ford pregame show. Next up, the tip-off. Alabama and Missouri from Tuscaloosa on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
This has been the Ford pregame show. Ford, visit your local Ford dealer. Proud sponsor of the Crimson Tide. Crimson Tide basketball is also brought to you by Texaco, proven unbeatable mileage. Texaco with Tecron, driving performance. BASF, we create chemistry. Auto Owners Insurance, visit RollTide.com/autoowners to partner with an independent Alabama agent. And by Guthrie's, America's original chicken finger restaurant, and now a proud partner of the Crimson Tide. Get ready. Alabama Crimson Tide basketball is next on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
At Red Diamond, we know that there's simply nothing better than the perfect sip of fresh brewed iced tea. And we've been working hard to make sure choosing Red Diamond is always easy, with only simple ingredients, water, tea leaves, and pure cane sugar, or no sugar. We make sure our tea tastes like, well, tea. Stop by your local cooler and pick up a gallon for a perfect sip today. Red Diamond, perfect's not easy.
Today's highlight is brought to you by Toyota. At home or on the road, they're never the underdog. Toyota, let's go places. Get 3.99% APR for 36 months on a new 2024 Toyota RAV4. Offer valid through January 31st, 2024. Zero down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.52 monthly payment for every $1,000 financed. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
On your next trip to Tuscaloosa, check out the Residence Inn Tuscaloosa. Located along the banks of the Black Warrior River, our all-suite hotel is just a short drive from the University of Alabama in downtown Tuscaloosa. Our accommodations are ideal for any traveler, whether you're staying overnight or for an extended stay. Our hotel is devoted to giving Tide fans an amazing experience from start to finish, including a free football game day shuttle for guests. At Residence Inn Tuscaloosa, it's not just a room, it's a residence. And we're proud to be a preferred hotel partner of the Crimson Tide. If you're looking for the best selection in Crimson Tide apparel, look no further than the Soup Store. The Soup Store is every Bama fan's ultimate destination for the hottest gear and accessories, with three great locations around campus to serve you: in Tuscaloosa on campus at the University Student Center, on the Strip in front of Bryant-Denny Stadium, and on Bryant Drive. If you can't get to Tuscaloosa, shop the Soup Store online at soupstore.ua.edu. The Soup Store is a proud partner of Alabama Athletics.
you sick of pretending to like boring hard seltzers that leave you feeling bloated? Tired of drinking the same old light beer? No time to make a mixed drink with all those complicated ingredients? Then it's time for you to try something different. BeatBox is the official party punch of the University of Alabama. Packing ABV punch, each BeatBox is bursting with delicious flavors. BeatBox is low sugar and resealable, so you can always take the party on the go. There ain't no party like a BeatBox party. Roll Tide. Please drink responsibly. Must be 21 or older.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. Sirius XM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got you covered. On SEC Radio, there is complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along on the Sirius XM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now you can get 3 months of Sirius XM free. Subscribe now. See all for details at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Here we go. It's time for Alabama Crimson Tide basketball on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Baseline at six. Stop. Follow-away shot from bottom. The stop, the layup, count it, and he is fouled. 3 seconds, two, at one. The win. It's gone. It's gone. And it's gone.
Crimson Tide basketball is brought to you by Konecka Sausage, the official smoked sausage of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Barkley GMC, Tuscaloosa's leader. Barkley makes it easy. Chick-fil-A, it's the little things that matter at Chick-fil-A. Texaco, proven unbeatable mileage. Texaco with Tecron, driving performance. And by Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Turn it up. It's game time.
Along with Bryan Passink, Tom Stipe, Jerry Kelly, Roger Hoover across the way. I'm Chris Stewart. So glad to have you with us. Here's Tony Giles with the introduction of our starters.
First, our visitors from Columbia, Missouri, the Tigers of the University of Missouri. At forward, a 6'6 graduate from Dubuque, Iowa, number 35, Noah Carter. At center, a 7'5 graduate from Little Rock, Arkansas, number 75, Connor Vanover. At guard, a 6'5 junior from Kansas City, Kansas, number 2, Tamar Bates. At guard, a 5'10 graduate from Orlando, Florida, number 10, Nick Honor. And at guard, a 6'3 graduate from Louisville, Kentucky, number 55, Sean East II. Missouri's assistant coaches are David Nutt and Kyle Smith-Peters. The associate head coach is C.Y. Young, and the Tigers' head coach is Dennis Gates.
And as they drop the lights here at Coleman Coliseum, in a matter of moments, they will introduce the starters for the home team. Why don't we pause 10 seconds so our local stations can identify themselves to you. Welcome to the Crimson Tide Sports Network. Considering the northern half of the state has very little chance to get to us here tonight in Tuscaloosa to be a part of our crowd, a good one has assembled here at Coleman Coliseum. Alabama students back in school showing up at Coleman Coliseum tonight. A great turnout from the students and the general fan base doing a nice job, all things considered, as well. The Tide coming in at 11-5 on the year, 3-0 in the SEC. Here are the Bama starters.
For Alabama, starting five. At forward, a 6'11 senior from Devil's Lake, North Dakota. Number two, Grant Nelson. At forward, a 6'10 senior from Seabrook, South Carolina. Number 23, Nick Pringle. At guard, a 6'3 graduate from Woodbury, New Jersey. Number 55, Aaron Estrada. At guard, a 6'6 sophomore from Dallas, Texas. Number 3, Rylan Griffin. And at guard, a 6'1 senior from Muscle Shoals, Alabama. Number one, Mark Sears. The assistant coaches are Austin Claunch, Ryan Pannon, and Preston Murphy. And Alabama's head coach is Nate Oates. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Alabama basketball.
You heard Mark Sears being among those introduced by Tony Giles as one of the starters, and Bryan, well-deserved honor for him being named the SEC Player of the Week. Hard to believe it's the first time he's earned that designation. I say that because he's played so well but hasn't been in Tuscaloosa that long. And by the way, he had teammates last year that were snatching up Player of the Week faster than he could get a shot at it himself.
And he had a teammate in Brandon Miller that was SEC Player of the Year. And right now, if they had to vote, it would probably be Mark Sears. I think Mark Sears and the guy that he shared Player of the Week with, Dalton Connect, right now 1-2 in the SEC. A long way to go, but Mark Sears has been as improved as anybody in college basketball. One of the best players, if not the very best, in the SEC, leading the SEC in scoring at over 20 a game, top five in the SEC in field goal percentage, top two in three-point percentage. He's shooting 61% from three in three conference games. He's handling the ball, finding open teammates, top 10 in assists. Every meaningful statistical offensive category, Mark Sears is in there. He's also a much improved defender. He's worked really hard on his strength, his conditioning, his explosiveness, and he is one of the top players in the country, but he's got some help. Right now, Rylan Griffin, the sophomore, playing well. Grant Nelson coming off of his best defensive performance of his Alabama career. And also, Latrell Reitzel off the bench. Had 19 against Mississippi State, starting to hit his groove. Going to need to have all those guys playing well against a desperate Missouri team. They've gone 0-3 in the SEC, but they're better than that. They're capable of going on a win streak. Just don't want it to happen here tonight.
Never thought of Nick Pringle as short by any stretch. He is 6'10". But when I saw who he will jump center against come out, I realized, okay, 7'5", Connor Vanover. Climb up his chest, Nick. Get to the jump ball as Steven Anderson's about to throw it in the air. And we'll get started. Bama in white, Mizzou in black. Ball's in the air, and Nick got to it first. And the jump ball is indeed controlled by the Crimson Tide. Mark Sears bringing it front court to our left. Goes to the left wing, takes it to the baseline, gets cut off there, and now we'll back it out in direct traffic as he gets to the left wing. Gives it off to Estrada. Aaron will try to drive. Goes behind the back with the dribble a couple of times and hands it off to Mark. Shot clock's down to 9. It's at 8. It's at 7. Sears into the paint at 6. At 5. Spin, shoots, fall away. No good. Rebound tipped by Griffin and then run down in the corner by East. And here comes Mizzou into the front court with their first possession of the basketball game.
Well defended first possession for Missouri. Tough shot from Mark Sears. Rylan Griffin in great position to get the offensive rebound, but couldn't hold on to it.
Bates trying to dump it into the low post. Can't. Bama defends it well. Far side to Honor. Now they go to East with a shot clock at 6-5. East with it at 4. At 3. Gives it off to Bates at 2. At 1. Just does get the shot off in time, and he knocks it down as the buzzer sounds. 2-0, Missouri the quick advantage. Here's Bama the other way rapidly with Sears. Mizzou filling in defensively as Sears will drive to the elbow. Throws the skip pass left side. Catch and shoot 3. Bottom. Grant Nelson, the bank first 3 to start the scoring for Alabama.
The one area that Grant Nelson has struggled is knocking down 3's. Great sign early in this game to knock it down.
East, step back, fall away from 12 on the near side. Got it to go. And the mid-range jumper makes it a 4-3 advantage for the Tigers. Estrada back the other way for Alabama. Gets inside the paint. Nice lob, catch, layup, bucket, and a foul. Nick Pringle, what a play on a beautiful assist. And Bama will have a chance for an and one.
High pick and roll, beautiful pass from Mark Sears. And Nick Pringle doesn't come down with it. Able to catch it, turn in one motion. It's great to have a vertical leap, and that hang time is Nick Pringle able to finish off the glass and a chance for the three-point play.
Nick Pringle efficient in his last ball game. 6 minutes, 5 fouls. he had to do it quickly. Didn't have a lot of time on the floor, and that's going to be a pump fake, and that will be, unfortunately. And that's almost the yips right there, Bryan, for a guy who's been struggling from the free throw line. He literally went to shoot it, stopped as everybody came in the lane, and that is a violation.
Well, he struggled, and also he shot it one-handed last year. It almost looked like he went back to that and then at the last minute put his left hand on it. And you can't pump fake from the free throw line, and no chance for the three-point play there.
East with the basketball as Bama leads it 5-4. Now Honor working left of the circle, tries to get it to the near side, does with the dribble, gives it back to East with a shot clock at 3. It's at 2, it's at 1, step back, fall away off 1 foot, and he's made 3 buckets basically all the same way, Bryan.
Yeah, well defended by Rylan Griffin. But Sean East, as we talked about, one of the best guards in the SEC, averaging 17 a game, and all three of those have been difficult, but he's been able to knock them down.
Might correct myself, it was Bates who made the first bucket, but East the next two since. East almost commits the foul, but Griffin able to get to the loose ball with the deck first. Now it's Sears, whips a pass, now into the left corner. Estrada, 3, no good. Nelson tipped it to keep it alive, but Bates will control it. Goes downhill, runner up and off the glass and in. A nice shot by Bates in transition. Tamar Bates now with a couple of buckets to go with 4 points as well from East, and it's an 8-5 Missouri advantage. Sears with the basketball. Skip pass all the way left side. Estrada all alone. 3, bottom.
Alabama has the ability to get hot. The best three-point shooting team in the SEC. Aaron Estrada wide open in rhythm, knocks it down.
Another bank first three for the Tide is inside. They go to Carter. Deflected by Estrada once. Tried to get it again and somehow able to step through and get the layup to go. Noah Carter to make it a 10-8 advantage. Now here is Estrada the other way. Swings it over to Sears, right side. Deep three ball, too strong. Rebound tipped and controlled by Vanover. Actually, it hit the front of the rim, skipped to the back, went off to the deck, and now it's East the other way for Missouri. East crossing over, going to his left, getting across the lane, takes it all the way to the far wing before giving it up now to Honor, top of the key. Honor on the drive, stopping, looking, spinning, bounce pass out to East with the shot clock again under 10. East working against Nelson, loses it on the way up, controlled by Bama. Pringle to Sears, 3-on-2, weaves away from trouble, whips a pass intended for Estrada, but stolen away by Vanover.
A rare mistake from Mark Sears as he knocks the ball out of bounds. He was open at the three-point line, but tried to make a pass. Connor Vanover, 7-5 with that wingspan, gets the steal. Alabama's got to get some stops. Finally, a stop as Missouri starting off this game 5-for-6 from the field.
Timeout on the floor, 15:57 remaining in the opening half. Missouri 10, Bama 8 on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Here at Payless Drugs, we continue to be just what the doctor ordered. We know getting the medicine you need is especially important during these unique times. And for your safety and convenience, we offer a drive-thru at every location. Plus, we have prescription delivery and contactless pickup at all locations. Now's the time to take care of your immunization needs. Stop by any of our convenient locations today.
Just what the doctor
Your business has a story to tell. Let Fast Signs help you tell it using the right mix of visual communication solutions like signs, banners, digital displays, vehicle graphics, mobile marketing, and so much more. Give Fast Signs your business challenge and they'll come up with a plan to grow your business, reach more customers, and accomplish more than you ever thought possible. Fast Signs, make your statement. Visit Fast Signs at their new location just past Tuscaloosa Ford on the left. Locally owned and operated by Milton and Gina Chancellor.
Tonight's game between Alabama and Mizzou is presented by Mercedes-Benz. The vehicles are all electric. The feeling is all Mercedes. Bama down 2 at the first break, 10-8 to Mizzou here at Coleman. Keep up with everything Alabama with the Alabama Crimson Tide mobile app presented by Cadence Bank. Download it now for free at the App Store and Google Play. We've always known this, but neither rain nor sleet nor snow can keep Roger Hoover away from the Bama sideline.
Absolutely. I made it just in time. Coach Oates talking to the Crimson Tide about getting stops, pointed out that Alabama didn't have a stop on Missouri until the last possession when Grant Nelson was able to do so. So again, getting stops, playing with a sense of urgency, really important here, Bryan, moving forward for the Crimson Tide.
Yeah, great start for Alabama on the offensive end, knocking down shots, finding open teammates. A few mistakes on that end of the floor, but Alabama, the number one offensive team in the country, has been so good all year long. on the offensive end. Defensively, it's been up and down. A great defensive performance for the most part the last few games, especially in Starkville against Mississippi State. Not a great start for Alabama on the defensive end. Missouri finally missed its first shot. They made their first five in a row. Alabama got a stop. Need to see more of that here in the first half.
Tell you what, as I turn around and look behind us, Bryan, we're used to Crimson Chaos filling up their section, but man, it is awesome to see so many other students that have made their way here, basically packing it out right behind us, and a great turnout from the Alabama students, and a great job on the part of Greg Byrne and his staff to make sure that, hey, the folks that can get here for our game tonight had a great spot to sit and watch it.
Yeah, able to move down and, you know, as you mentioned, really good crowd, great, great student section, but so many from the northern part of the state not able to get here, so those that are here have been able to move a little closer to the floor.
Mo Diabati, Latrell Reitzel, Sam Walters have checked in, joining Nelson and Estrada on the floor for the Tide as spinning down into the post as Carter got cut off and had it knocked away and stolen. Here's Bama coming the other direction, looking to tie or take the lead with the three. Estrada working inside the arc. Swings it around to Reitzel. One more. Walters, left side, three. Too strong. Rebound tipped and fought for and saved by Estrada. Great work by Aaron. Now trying to shake free in the corner. Swings it back to Sam. Try it again, baby. Sam Walters knocking home a bank first three, and Alabama leads it 11-10.
And give Aaron Estrada credit for getting the offensive rebound over Noah Carter. Sam Walters, no hesitation on the second opportunity, and knocks it down.
Man over down low, couldn't finish it, and Alabama gets the rebound. Estrada running the other way. We got numbers. Estrada stomping on the wing, looks into the low post. Nice save, Diabati. Back to Estrada. Too strong on the three, and the rebound fought for, and a foul is going to be whistled on the Crimson Tide. Energy, effort, certainly there out of the gate for Alabama.
Well, and that's what you want to see against a team in Missouri that has struggled. Alabama needs to continue that killer instinct that we saw in Starkville on Saturday. Can't overlook Missouri, a team that is dangerous enough to beat you. Alabama coming out with energy, especially on the offensive end, and now putting stops back-to-back possessions.
Jesus Carrillero Martin into the ball game for Mizzou, along with Trent Pierce. Carrillero with the basketball. Driving, had it knocked away, stolen. Walters with it now. Hands it off wisely to Estrada, who brings it down the left sideline. Works on the near wing. Gets into the paint. Schemes it over. Three ball. Good. Latrell Reitzel knocks home the bank first three, and Alabama has a 14-10 advantage.
Defense leading to offense. Sam Walters gets the steal. Dropped it off to Aaron Estrada, who makes the right decision, finding Reitzel on the wing.
Bates with the ball on the near side. Looking low, nothing there. Tried to get it to Vanover and does, just beyond the reach of Diabati, who tried to gamble on the play. Now it's East driving to the right elbow. Stopping, shooting, missing, rebound. Diabati had it, got fouled. Mo Diabati up high, battling hard, got knocked to the deck. And Bama will have possession after team foul number two is called on the Tigers.
And that's why Mo Diabati's in the game. He's earned more playing time. Great effort attacking the defensive rebound, going after the ball. Missouri's in pretty good position, but Mo Diabati went after it and got fouled as a result.
Vanover is sucking wind over there. The big seven-footer has got to check out. He is replaced by Aid Shaw. 6'8", 205 is Shaw. And here comes Bama front court, leading it by four. Diabati will throw it down low. Nelson the catch, missed the layup as he was challenged on the play by the Tigers, and here comes Mizzou the other way. Driving East to the right wing. Still with the dribble alive, throws a pass all the way to the far side, caught by Kurt Lewis, who then loses it out of bounds. Possession will belong to the Crimson Tide.
Aaron Estrada does so many things well for this Alabama team. We know he can score, knock down shots, but great decision on the offensive end, finding open teammates right there, able to get the deflection, his second steal of the game.
Reitzel to inbound it for Alabama. By the way, Nelson has checked out, and Muhammad Wagi comes in to replace him as Estrada will drive, goes down the lane, lost it off his foot, though, out of bounds on the dribble drive. Bama able to get to the bucket now with Vanover out of the basketball game.
Yeah, Alabama wants to attack, and as we mentioned, this Missouri team, top 10 in the nation in blocked shots, but They've got other guys besides Vanover. Alabama wants to continue to attack, but Missouri does foul. Should be some opportunities for Alabama to get to the free throw line in this one.
Carrillero will hand it off to East. East driving to his right, throws it into the paint. Touch pass goes to Shaw, who lost it. Swung his arm, no whistle on that. Pierce tries the three, misses it. Rebound to Abadi, and he gets grabbed clearly by Carrillero, and the foul on the 6'7", 225-pounder will give possession to Alabama.
When you play really hard and fight for every rebound on both ends of the floor, you end up in the right position. Mo Diabate has put pressure on the Missouri defense and got a couple of rebounding fouls because of the effort of Diabate.
Reitzel inbounds it. Latrell coming off of a great game offensively his last time out. Wagee trying to dribble it. Now Missouri, after the steal, comes the other way, misses a three in the corner. Rebound grabbed by Wagee and gives it up to Diabate. Diabate will bring it front court. I love the two Mo's, but I wish one of them would find a guard. Diabate swings it over right side. Reitzel catch and shoot three, short. Rebound claimed by Diabate, but that's going to be a push. Push off on Mo Diabate. And that will give possession back to the Tigers. Team foul number two on Alabama. Three team fouls have been called on the visitors from Columbia. And here comes Jaron Stevenson in for the Crimson Tide. And Diabate will check out.
And little Mo Diabate talking to the officials, saying he was held right there. May have pushed off just a little bit, but love the effort as he goes to the Alabama bench.
So Alabama with Reitzel, Sears, Walters, Wagee, and Stevenson as their five. Tigers bring it front court. Carrillero pivots, throws it into the right corner. Caught there by Honor. He'll dribble to the wing. He'll throw a swift pass over left side. Three ball is up and missed badly by Carter. Long rebound saved by Wagee and brought ahead now by Bama. Onto the left side, driving is Reitzel. He will work it over to Sears. Fakes a three, drives, dishes back to Reitzel. He'll drive, gets underneath the basket, flips it ahead now to Stevenson. He'll give it off to Sears. Mark with 15 on the shot clock. Has it, top of the arc, three ball, bottom.
Two had a foot on the line. High ball screen, and Mark Sears has given up a couple open shots where he didn't take them right there, rose up and knocked it down.
16-10, Bama. Carrillero now tries a three, and that one is good. Back to a one-possession game, 16-13 Alabama with 11:43 and moving. And we got a whistle and a timeout called by Missouri, and that brings us to a media timeout. 11:43 to play. We're in the first half here at Coleman Coliseum. 16-13 score. Good guys on top here on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
A caring man took a walk. He saw people suffering. Anxiety ran high. Hatred rose. I'll prepare a feast and bring them together, he thought. But some refused to join him. He was heartbroken because he wanted everyone to be filled. Not with food and wine, but with compassion.
Jesus welcomed all to the table. Visit HeGetsUs.com to learn more.
There's a lot of trash talk in basketball, but great teams let their performance do the talking. Like the Ford F-150 truck with smart tech that'll help win the day and leave the competition speechless. That's why F-150 is the best-selling full-size pickup in Alabama. Greatness starts here. See your local Ford dealer, proud sponsor of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Based on S&P Global Mobility Total, U.S. new vehicle registrations for the standard full-size pickup segment RYTD April 2023. Some models, trims, and features may not be available or may be subject to change.
.43 to go in the first half at Coleman Coliseum. Bama's up on Mizzou 16-13. On your next trip to T-Town, stay at the Residence Inn located at the banks of the Black Warrior River. An all-suite hotel just a short drive from campus in downtown and ideal for any traveler. Whether staying overnight or an extended stay, Residence Inn is not just a room, it's a residence. Proud to be the preferred hotel partner of the Crimson Tide. Roger Hoover is across the way. What are you hearing on the Bama bench?
Well, they like the intensity they're seeing so far on defense, getting more stops. As we talked about the last media timeout, Alabama wasn't getting enough stops early on, but Missouri just won for its last seven, so the attention to detail, the sense of urgency on the defensive end, Bryan, is closer to what Alabama wants to play with moving forward.
Yeah, Alabama's been better since the first media timeout on the defensive end, getting the job done defensively, rebounding the ball. But this Missouri team has some guys that can get hot from the perimeter. They shoot a bunch of threes. They haven't made them at a high clip, but they're capable of getting it going. They just knocked down another one, or their first of the game. Right now, Missouri 1-for-4 from the three-point line. Alabama 4-for-9 from deep, getting good looks on the offensive end. This Missouri team does a good job of blocking shots. They also do a good job of creating turnovers, but their field goal percentage defense is not one of the better teams in the SEC. If Alabama can take care of the ball, they should get open looks, and right now they've been knocking them down, especially from deep.
Alabama breaks its huddle with Rylan Griffin, Mark Sears, Nick Pringle, Jaron Stevenson, and Latrell Reitzel Jr. The Tide will bring it ahead, facing looks like a zone defense this trip down for Missouri. Sears takes it to the right wing, feeds it to Stevenson. Around the horn, Reitzel back to Stevenson, top of the arc. Over on the wing to Sears, right side. Spins away from trouble, throws it out to Reitzel. Shot clock down to 11 seconds as Reitzel drives left side. Cut off, gives it to Sears. Sears splitting defenders, driving the lane. Tried to dump it off, saved by Stevenson. Now on the drive, Griffin at two on the shot clock, rattles it in. Got it to go on what was less than ideal very late in that shot clock.
It was almost a turnover, but it was a beautiful pass from Mark Sears to Jaron Stevenson. He wasn't able to handle it. If he does, it's a layup or dunk. But ultimately, Alabama gets the field goal. Tough mid-range jumper from Rylan Griffin.
10:55 to play, first half. Bama leading it 18-13. East, now they'll throw it into the low post where Sears had it and couldn't hang on. If he just lets the ball go, Bryan, it's going to be Bama's basketball. It was going to be a turnover as the pass intended for Carter was well beyond his reach, but unfortunately Sears couldn't snare it.
Yeah, and I'll tell you why he tried to grab it, because Alabama's trying to play fast, turning defense into offense. Bama doesn't want to take the ball out. They want to push it in transition, so Mark Sears not able to hold on to it.
Carrillo, as the shot clock is winding down, tries a desperation heave from the far wing. It is short. An air ball, and the clock expires, and Bama will get it with 10:39 to go first half.
The leading scorer in the SEC, Mark Sears, with some great defense right there, forced a difficult shot.
Here's Reitzel bringing it ahead again against the Missouri zone. They go to that with their seven-footer, Vanover, on the bench. Reitzel driving, dishing back to Sears. Splitting defenders, had it poked away, nearly stolen, but Reitzel was the first one to the deck, and they're going to call now a foul on Latrell. A late whistle from A.J. Desai as Reitzel had already picked up the basketball before the whistle was blown, and unfortunately for Latrell, that's going to be his second personal foul.
Great effort from Latrell Reitzel. Got on the floor for the loose ball, thought it was going to go the other way. He'll have to check out, but love the effort from the veteran.
Two personals, three team fouls now on Alabama. Matches the number from Missouri. Pierce with the basketball near side, pivots, looks, throws it right side where it was caught by Robinson. He'll try to give it back, but it's stolen. Sears racing to the basket, lays it up. It wouldn't go, and the tip wouldn't go. And here comes Missouri the other way with numbers. Carrillo laying it up and in for two. That was a tough transition there for Bama as Missouri gets a bucket on the other end.
Great transition defense by Missouri. Rylan Griffin in great position to get the offensive rebound, but the bounce of the ball goes to Missouri.
And they're going to call a foul on Missouri.
That's a four-point swing. Alabama had numbers. It was a one on none, but Missouri able to get back, force a difficult shot. Rylan Griffin all by himself, but the ball kind of hung on the rim. Otherwise, Rylan would have tipped it in or in position for a tip dunk. Instead, it goes to Missouri. That starts the Tigers' fast break, and they were able to score.
So Bama with the basketball. The inbounds goes to Pringle, gives it back to Estrada. 15 on the shot clock as Aaron looks to his right, still with the dribble alive. Picks it up, needs help, gives it off to Stevenson. Jaron, catch, shoot, three, miss, rebound, Estrada. Underneath, spin, shoot, scores off the glass.
Another offensive rebound for Aaron Estrada. Had a kick out to Sam Walters earlier in this game. This time takes it himself and finishes.
Alabama leading it 20-15 with 9 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in the opening half. Tigers will throw it into the low post. Carrillo trying to back down on Pringle. Spins right, flips up a shot that misses. Weak side rebound, Stevenson. Jaron hands it off to Sears. Mark gets it to the center of the floor. He'll survey things, plays off of one screen, tries to dribble away from a double team, picks it up, needs help, somehow stepped through, flipped it over to Estrada. One more in the corner to Griffin. Riding on the drive, a bounce pass, Pringle put it up, had it blocked and got fouled.
That's a great job by Mark Sears. Missouri had the double team trap right by the half court line. The strength of Mark Sears, able to split it. The extra pass from Rylan Griffin gets it to Pringle, who went up strong, took the contact. He'll go to the line for two.
Pringle shooting the first of two. He was about to try one earlier and had a hitch in the wagon and couldn't let it fly. He now shoots it and makes it with that one hand that you talked about and all season.
He shot it better last year with one hand, and he transitioned to shooting more traditional two-handed shot. The problem with Nick and his stroke is sometimes his left hand gets a little too involved, get a little side spin, and this time goes one-handed and nothing but net on back-to-back free throws.
Made them both, and they were beautiful. It's 22-15 Bama with 8:40 remaining in the first half. East with a dribble for the Tigers. Double team, he'll bring it back left side, feeds it off top of the arc, Robinson. Robinson flips it into the low post. Spinning into a double team is Carter. Needs help, nearly walked. Ball gets poked away into the hands of the Tigers, and a rebound after the miss by Estrada. He spins away from trouble. Aaron races into the front court. Stops, looks, down low. Kick out into the corner, Nelson. Estrada around the horn. Sears going to the lane. Hands it off. Bingo, the layup for two.
Once again, Mark Sears gets in the lane. Thought he was going to go up, but able to dump it off to Nick Pringle, who knocks in the layup.
Crowd making noise here at Coleman Coliseum with under 8 minutes to go in the half, and Bama's biggest lead at 9. Robinson with the basketball, feeds it to the far side. Giving it off, they go to Shaw. Now needing help with it is Maya. He'll hand it off, ball gets poked into the hands of East. East on the drive, goes down the lane, off the glass, no. Ball tipped out long, rebound fought for, tie up, I believe, or is that going to be a foul as players get tangled up? Estrada wanted none of the whatever from Robinson, and Nate Oates is not putting up with anything either. Tells him to get out of his huddle. Players jawing at him, and they don't want any part of Coach Oates, who said Happy New Year to a couple of them. And Alabama's crowd enjoying the fiery nature of their head coach and the Bama faithful. And oh yeah, this guy looks familiar. Athletic Director Greg Byrne with a special guest.
About Coach DeBoer. Students, thanks so much everybody for being here. Here's your new football coach, Coach DeBoer. Is right over here, right?
As he points at the student section.
I know where to find you. I know where to find you. Hey, it is so awesome to be here. It's happened really fast. We got a lot of great news coming out, whether it's recruiting, our staff. Can't wait to ingrain myself in this community. What a special place. What a special place. The standard is Alabama. The standard is Alabama. Can't wait to be here. Let's keep supporting all of the athletic teams. Roll Tide.
And we're back after this Alabama from Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Sometimes I just cannot believe all the storms we've gone through here. I can only hope that we'll be able to leave this house to you one day, baby. You're our legacy.
Planning for these disasters will make sure we're safe. And it's the best way to protect that legacy.
Protect your legacy. Visit ready.gov/plan for the tools and tips you need to start your emergency preparedness plan today. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Hi, I'm Danica Patrick. Watching my nieces grow, play, and learn is amazing, but not every child gets to be carefree. 1 in 6 kids in the U.S. are hungry. This breaks my heart, and it's something that Feeding America is working to change. Each year, the Feeding America network of food banks rescues billions of pounds of good food that would have gone to waste and gives it to families in need. To help, visit feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Tonight's radio affiliate of the game, Alabama 100, 100.7 WCKF in Headland. Go to Crimson Tide Sport Network Facebook page. Follow us and tell us where you're listening for a chance to win two free combo meals from Jack's. Thank you for tuning in to the Crimson Tide Sports Network for Alabama basketball. A little excitement at the half there, or at the timeout, Roger. A little spirited discussion across the way. Were you in the middle of that?
No, I tried to straight away. Right now, they are discussing double technicals, so we'll try to get some details coming up in that moment. There will be double technicals against Alabama and Missouri, though. Try to get more confirmation in a moment, guys.
Thank you, Roger. Brian, we could see it that at the end of the play, just before the timeout, instead of a jump ball, it was a foul on Aaron Estrada, and then over near the Alabama huddle, may have been Coach Nate Oates who gets the Alabama tee. Not sure who it's going to be for the Tigers. We'll see.
Well, intense game.
Yeah.
And both teams getting after it. And how about this crowd? I mean, you know, it's the roads are not good. A lot of people, a lot of fans couldn't get here like they would like, but you move down some students, and it's not that Nate Oates would know anything about NIT crowds, but it's like an NIT crowd in that they were able to move all the students and fans down closer to the court, and it is a great atmosphere.
Roger, could you pick up what happened?
Yeah, they did review that to see if there were technicals on the play, but I've been told it's just a foul on Aaron Estrada, nothing extra.
Outstanding. Great report. Thank you for that, Roger Hoover. A little chaotic here for a while. Appreciate you bringing that to light. Is now East will flip it on the left side. They're going to call a foul on Riley Griffin.
And so anytime that players get into it and they have to separate players, benches, they're going to call it a little tighter.
Sure.
And Alabama's got to be aware for that. That wasn't much of a foul, little ticky-tack foul, but that's what officials are going to do in these situations on both ends of the floor.
Tigers inbound it. Side court again, 24-15. Alabama with the lead, Missouri with the basketball. 7:18 and ticking. Time left here in the opening half. Backing his way down, spinning, shooting, and missing is Carter. Rebound tipped, out of bounds, touch last by, I believe, Missouri. Officials are talking it over, and it will indeed be Bama basketball. Joe Lindsay coming over and helping A.J. Desai out, who was not certain who had touched it last, and the overrule does give it to Alabama.
That's really good defense by Rylan Griffin against Noah Carter, 6'8", power forward. Rylan Griffin can guard your point guard or your power forward. Did a great job forcing a difficult shot.
Right side, Estrada three ball, way too strong, and it goes out of bounds. That was an NBA three. Unfortunately, he had his toes right up on the college line, and it went safely right over into the baseline, and Bama will see Missouri bring it ahead with the tide on top by 9. Here's Honor with the basketball, playing off of a screen. Has it to the top of the arc, directing traffic with a shot clock down to 15 seconds. Stepping back, shooting a deep three, and knocking it home is Nick Honor, the graduate student who's averaging 10.5 points per game.
And he's our best three-point shooter on the season. Got matched up with Grant Nelson, wasn't able to get a contest.
Alabama goes with Sears. Going down the lane, stepping through, kicking it out. Griffin all alone, three ball, perfect.
Set up by Mark Sears, got in the lane. There wasn't much room, but Sears able to get in the lane past a couple of Missouri Tigers. The defense came to help. Rylan Griffin all alone knocks it down.
A bank first three gives Bama the 27-18 lead as Honor gives it off to East. On the drive, stepping on the sideline before he made his move was Sean East the second. So possession goes back to the Crimson Tide as Mabor Majok checks out of the game for Missouri. And in to replace him will be Jordan Butler, a 7-foot freshman, 230 pounds. He will defend Nick Pringle down in the post as the Tide will bring it ahead. Here's Sears. Bringing it left side. Dribbling, looking, lob. Pringle missed the dunk with one hand, and the rebound is secured by the Tigers. Would have brought the house down. Instead, it brought down the wrath of Nate Oates. And now on the other end, the three is missed. And then the putback is good by Noah Carter.
Missed opportunity on the offensive end. That's when offensively, Nate just needs to lay that in, try to make the highlight reel dunk. And on the offensive end,
like that. They ran the same play. He used two hands that time, and he didn't spill the milk.
Well, in the pass was a little more on target. On the previous play, Mark Sears threw it a little too high to get the alley-oop dunk. This time, right on target, Nick Pringle throws it down with two hands.
Carter trying to back his way down on Pringle. Steps into a double team, goes with a reverse layup, a beauty, to make it 29-22. 4:50 to play in the half. Here's Bama with Sears throwing it down low to Pringle. Spinning, shooting with a left hand and scoring. And Pringle has been at the rim three straight times. Got two of them to go. And a steal by Estrada. Ahead to Sears on the wing. Mark, three ball, too strong. Weak side rebound claimed, though, by Pringle. Or, excuse me, by Griffin. Ryland giving it off to Pringle. Back to Griffin. Back to Pringle. Whips a pass to the cutter, Estrada. Back out. Bama works it. Griffin, top of the arc. Three. No good. Rebounded, though. Pringle in the corner. Estrada driving into the lane. Spin. And scores.
Was beautiful, so smooth. Aaron Estrada, second chance opportunity as Missouri gets the timeout. And listen to this Coleman Coliseum crowd.
Cats have their tongues hanging out right now as the Tides rolled up a 33-22 lead with 4:09 to play first half on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Okay, confession time. I just shopped Kohl's clearance and I might have gone a little overboard. But who can blame me with all the major markdowns going on? I saved 70% on so many great finds, like cozy fleece sweats, comfy PJs, a cute sweater, stylish jeans, and I could keep going. Trust me, you do not want to miss out on Kohl's clearance major markdowns. And if you see me there again, no you didn't. Select styles. Up to 70% clearance offer ends January 21st. Some exclusions apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
Bama and Mizzou on a cold Tuesday night is presented by Mercedes-Benz. The vehicles are all electric. The feeling is all Mercedes. The feeling is all Bama. Up 11, 33-22, 4:09 to go in the first half. Bama on a roll, Roger Hoover.
Certainly are, and a couple things to keep in mind in the Alabama huddle they talked about. The urgency continues need to be there, and Nate Oates said specifically, let's turn it up for these final 4 minutes. And also, Coach Austin Pinone talking about what, Ryan Pinone talking about what needs to happen moving forward. Alabama doesn't need to allow Missouri to get to 30, so that's a number to keep in mind moving forward. Right now, the Crimson Tide with a 33-22 lead, but Bryan trying to finish out this half the right way certainly is the message.
Yeah, Alabama playing with a ton of intensity, and that is led by the head coach, Nate Oates, getting fired up on the Alabama sideline, and his team has responded. Alabama's getting stops, knocking down shots, and how about Nick Pringle? Struggled in the game in Starkville, was in foul trouble, only played 6 minutes, had five fouls, as we talked about. In this one, he's got 10 points already in 11 minutes. He's been so effective getting to the free throw line, couple alley-oop dunks. His teammates have been able to find him. Nick Pringle responding in a big way after a tough game in Starkville.
Crimson Tide early on in this one. I say early on, we're 16 minutes into it now, but the Tide 13 of 26 from the field, including 5 of 14 from Bank First. Three-point range, also 13 boards for Alabama to 11 for the opposition. The Tide has gotten five steals, turned it over four times. They have forced seven Missouri turnovers, and they have picked up three steals of their own. Wagee, Stevenson, Reitzel, Griffin, and Estrada, the five on the floor for Nate Oates, Alabama Crimson Tide. Tigers to inbound at side court in front of the Bama bench. It's going to be Honor with the basketball. Honor dribbles to the left side. Keeps the dribble going, gives it off to Bates. Bates looking to the high post, feeding it off to Carolero. Carolero backing his way down against Reitzel. Stops, looks, skip pass far side to East. East from the wing, throws it all the way back. Carolero, right corner, his three is up and good. Jesus Carolero, the senior at 6'7", 225, has made it a 33-25 ball game. Bama with it, here's Estrada. Backing it out near center court, trying to work away from a potential double team. Gives it off to Griffin. Ryland weaving his way through traffic, gets to the elbow, and then brings it out beyond the arc. Griffin on the drive, going downhill, hands it off or tried to Agui, gets deflected to Reitzel. Spin, shoots, fall away, no. Rebound by Estrada, puts it up, wouldn't go. Rebound Estrada again, backs it out, shoots it again, still wouldn't go. Batted around again, ball on the deck, a scramble and a reach in. Noah Kick is going to be called on Alabama. Aaron Estrada did everything but score the basketball three straight times right there.
Yeah, great effort by Alabama and Aaron Estrada. Couple of offensive rebounds in traffic. We talked about this Missouri team, such a great shot blocking team. They didn't block a shot, but just a couple of guys in the area may have forced the miss, but great effort by Aaron Estrada. Talked about Aaron. He's been so close to some triple doubles this year. May get it tonight. 7 points, seven rebounds. Already four assists.
3 minutes left in the half. Here's Robinson with the basketball. Working to the top of the arc, trying to dribble away from Wagi. Feeds it off to Honor near side. Carolero now working against Walters. Goes baseline, nearly fell, but unloaded the pass in the corner to Butler. He'll feed it off to Robinson. Robinson down the lane, puts it up and in for two. 33-27, Missouri has cut it to six now as Stevenson brings it ahead for Alabama. Jaron dribbling away from trouble. Robinson bumping him the whole time and goes, who, me? Yep. Cuckoo, ka-choo, Mr. Robinson. That's going to be foul number one. Check that, his second personal foul, and 33-27 is now the score. Alabama on top. We'll see a change, and checking out will be Butler. And in to replace him will be Aiden Shaw. Bama tried to inbound it, but it was kicked by Bates. Mark Sears not on the floor right now and not on the Bama bench either.
He's in the Alabama locker room with Clark Holder. Not exactly sure what happened, but we will find out and let folks know.
Estrada loses the handle, and Missouri will come the other way. They got a chance to cut this thing under six right here. On the drive will be Honor. He'll swing it over near side. Carolero spinning, had it stripped by Estrada. Ball on the deck. Estrada, first one to the floor. He forces a tie up, and the arrow will favor Missouri. But great hustle again. Aaron Estrada has been all over the place in this ballgame, Bryan.
He's done everything. 7 points, six rebounds, four assists, a near steal right there. Great deflection. Make the ball go back to Missouri. But that was great effort by Estrada.
Two steals for Estrada already and almost a third. Sears with five assists in the ball game, but again, in the Bama locker room at the moment. Carolero driving, dishing, top of the arc, Honor off the bounce. His three is up and no good. Rebound tipped and a foul is going to be called on Missouri. That, I believe, is going to be on Jesus Carolero Martin.
And that's the 17th foul for Missouri. It'll either be Sam Walters or Grant Nelson going to the line. Alabama as a team did a great job of blocking out. One and one opportunity coming up for Sam Walters.
Sam Walters shooting one plus the bonus. 6'10 freshman from the Villages in Florida knocks home the first. Sam's averaging 7 points, 2.5 boards per game off the bench. Shooting 51% from three.
This Alabama team has some great three-point shooters. Not sure any of them are better than Sam Walters.
Missed the free throw on the second try, so just one of two for him, and it's 34-27 Alabama. Pass worked around the horn, near side, on a deep three is good. Can't afford to let them heat up. They have cut this thing down from 11 to just four. Bama runs the other way. Estrada to Stevenson in transition. Had it stripped, but got fouled. And Jared will go to the line to shoot two shots.
Nice pass inside. Alabama able to get it out of the net and run quickly. Jaron Stevenson had the ball inside. Not able to go up and immediately, but takes the foul. I believe this will be a one and one. I think the foul occurred before he went into a shooting motion.
It is one and one. You're exactly right, Bryan. So Stevenson's free throw is up. It's perfect. Alabama now 4 of 5 from the stripe in the early going. As we will see Carolero check out, and in to replace him will be Carter once again. Carter, their second leading scorer at 12.5 points per game. Sean East at 17 is tops on the squad there, as both free throws are good from Stevenson, and the Tide leads it by 6. 90 seconds remain in the half. Here comes Missouri front court with Robinson. He'll dribble to his right. Top of the arc. It's a return pass. Robinson against the Alabama D goes to the right wing. Steps back. Deep jumper. No good. Rebound fought for, and Nelson claims it for the Tide. Flips it ahead but threw it away, and then Missouri lost it, thankfully, out of bounds. That should have been a steal for Tamar Bates, but he couldn't hang on to it. As Bama tried the outlet there, and it was lobbed a little too lazily by Grant Nelson.
Yeah, didn't see the DB stepping in for the pick. Trying to lead Latrell Reitzel as he was getting double-teamed in the corner to start the Alabama fast break. It was a mistake, but fortunately, Alabama will get it back.
So Nelson to inbound it for the Tide. Somebody needs to come to the ball, and they do. It's going to be Estrada with it backcourt. A minute to play in the half. 20 remaining on the shot clock as Estrada dribbles right, throws a bounce pass to Nelson. Grant pivots, faces the basket, goes baseline. Whips a pass over to Stevenson. Had it stripped and stolen away. Taken away by the Tigers. 20-second differential. Shot clock and game clock. His honor brings it near side with 22 left on the possession.
Great to see Mark Sears coming back to the Alabama bench.
It is. A wrap around or just below the left knee as Honor has it, crosses over, steps back, has to unload a pass to Robinson. Far side, gives it off to Bates. Bates spinning, double team. Shot, got it to go. Boy, that is twice now. He's made highly contested shots in this ball game. Bama's going to get it front court and then try to use the timeout, but they lose the handle and Missouri takes it away. Walters lost it and the Tigers can hold it for one. 6 to play in the half. Honor jumper from 8 feet is good. And Nate Oates is not going to be in a good mood as the half comes to a close and Alabama's lead is down to just 2. Roger Hoover will have to wait. Television will get Coach Oates first. Bryan, your quick thoughts on especially the end of that first half.
Well, did not finish the way that Alabama wanted to. Didn't get stops, couple of turnovers, some mistakes. And this game, much closer than it probably should be, but Missouri hanging around with defense and making some shots.
36-34 in a moment. Coach Nate Oates in our conversation with Roger Hoover, brought to you by Cook's Pest Control and Centricon, the unbeatable combination for termite protection. Roger?
Coach, your thoughts on the first half?
Too many turnovers. You know, we had a bad start to the half. We had a bad close to the half. We were good in between, but we got to have consistent 20 minutes in the second half.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you, Roger. And again, thank you to Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. 36-34, Bama leads it, but only by 2 at the break here on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Do you say Roll Tide instead of hello? See elephants in the clouds? Never wear blue and orange together? If so, there's no better way to show your Crimson Tide pride than with the University of Alabama Regents Visa debit card and prepaid Regents Now card. As passionate as you are about Bama, Regions is even more passionate about celebrating your every financial win and helping you plan for the next one. To order your card, visit Regions.com/GoBama. Regions, official bank of the SEC. Member FDIC. Terms, conditions, and fees apply.
We've all been caught up in the little chores that pile up every day. The dishes in the sink, the trash that needs taking out, the pesky check engine light. What I want. Isn't it time to make a change and escape to a whole new world of possibilities? Where there's dinner without dishes, nights filled with adventure, and every day you feel like a winner. A little change can go a long way when you escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and on the Casinoverse app.
Favorite jeans, favorite shirt. I can make a sausage and I'm firing it up. Yeah, everybody knows how to get my grill on. Smell that flavor up and down the road. It's a little taste of heaven, and everybody knows. That's how I get my grill on. Kanaka sausage. It's just a little taste of heaven.
Holman Coliseum gives the Tide a big home court advantage. When it comes to your home, count on Tri-Green Equipment to give you a big tried and true advantage with our lineup of John Deere equipment. From riding mowers, compact utility tractors, gators, to large agricultural equipment, they've got serious game. Plus, the tried and true Tri-Green team is always there when you need an assist. Stop by one of our locations or visit TriGreenEquipment.com. Proud sponsors of Alabama Crimson Tide Basketball.
Crimson Tide Basketball is brought to you by Coke Zero Sugar. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Take a taste. Golden Flake, the official potato chip of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Cook's Pest Control and Centricon, the unbeatable combination for termite protection. And by Guthrie's, America's original chicken finger restaurant, and now a proud partner of the Crimson Tide. Now, on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield, welcome to the Toyota Halftime Report. Toyota, visit your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places.
Halftime in Tuscaloosa. It's Alabama 36, Missouri 34. Roger Hoover, glad to welcome you to the Toyota Halftime Report. Visit your local Toyota dealer or explore Toyota.com today and take advantage of the amazing deals in our full line of vehicles. No matter your destination, Toyota goes with you. Toyota, let's go places. It's Red Panda, one-of-a-kind entertainment, thrilling the fans here at Coleman Coliseum during halftime. So you hear those cheers coming out as we take a look at the individual scores for the Crimson Tide. Nick Pringle led the way with 10 points for Alabama in the first 20 minutes. It was Aaron Estrada with 7 points, and then 4 points from Sam Walters, 3 points from Latrell Reitzel Jr. Also for the Crimson Tide, Rylan Griffin, I mentioned 5 points, 2 points from Mark Sears, who went to the locker room with an ankle injury. We were told by Alabama that he is probable in this second half. So that's some encouraging news on Mark Sears. 3 points for Grant Nelson. Again, 2 points for Jaron Stevenson so far in the first half. Meanwhile, Missouri with 2 players, Nick Honor, as well as Jesus Carrillero, with 8 points to lead the way for the Tigers in the first 20 minutes of play. Again, our score here at halftime in Tuscaloosa. It's the Alabama Crimson Tide trying to move to 4-0 in SEC play with a 36-34 lead against Mizzou at halftime. We'll step aside and come back with more of the Toyota Halftime Report next. This is the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
You took the first step and quit smoking, but even former smokers may still be at risk for lung cancer. That's why SaveByTheScan.org wants you to know about a new low-dose CT scan that can detect lung cancer early. It takes only 60 seconds and could save your life. You took the first step, now take the next. Visit SaveByTheScan.org for a simple quiz to see if you're eligible and talk to your doctor about screening. SaveByTheScan.org is brought to you by the American Lung Association's Lung Force Initiative and the Ad Council.
My simple solution to the problem was remove people from the scene and help them feel safer.
In response to attacks against Asian Americans, Maddie Park raised over $250,000 to donate cab rides to the Asian community.
There is so much more work to be done. We really need to come together and tackle this issue as a community.
Support the Asian community. Learn how at lovehasnolabels.com. Brought to you by Love Has No Labels and the Ad Council.
Put your phone on D&D. That means that do not disturb when you're driving. And when you're going from point A to B, I need you to stay safe, please, so always sing with me. So put your phone on D&D. That means that do not disturb when you're driving. And when you're going from point A to B, I need you to stay safe, please, so always remember this beat.
Don't drive distracted. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
Hey, son, how are you feeling?
I'm fine, Pops.
What's on your mind?
I can't explain it. Never gave deep without a compass. Eyes waiting, started to wonder. Metamorphosis, loss of who you thought you was.
When your kid can't find the language, help them find the lyrics. Listen to the Sound It Out album and get tips and tools to start a conversation at soundedouttogether.org. Brought to you by Ad Council and Pivotal Ventures.
This copyrighted broadcast is an exclusive presentation of Learfield under the broadcasting rights granted by the University of Alabama. Reuse of this presentation is prohibited without the expressed written consent of the university and Learfield. Announcers are provided by Learfield and approved by the university.
This is Tom Stipe with your Alabama Power scoreboard. Alabama Power is proud to support the Crimson Tide. Halftime score from Coleman. Bama leads Mizzou 36-34. One final already in the league. They started the game early in Knoxville because of the snow and ice. Tennessee defeats the Florida Gators 85-66. Of course, Bama will face the Vols at Thompson Bowling this Saturday. We'll take a look at team stats next. This is the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
During the pandemic, we put a lot on hold. One of the things missed may have been keeping up with our regularly scheduled vaccinations. Hi, I'm Dallas Turner.
And I'm Rodell Williams. We're here to remind everyone across the state to protect the entire Bama community by staying up to date with all recommended vaccinations.
Flu season is coming, and COVID-19 continues to affect our community. So don't wait. Vaccinate.
Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM to learn more about how you can stay safe and up to date on vaccinations for you and your children.
Stay safe and roll time.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, looky, looky. Here comes Cookie. Cook's Pest Control.
At Red Diamond, we know that there's simply nothing better than the perfect sip of fresh-brewed iced tea. And we've been working hard to make sure choosing Red Diamond is always easy, with only simple ingredients, water, tea leaves, and pure cane sugar, or no sugar. We make sure our tea tastes like, well, tea. Stop by your local cooler and pick up a gallon for a perfect sip today. Red Diamond, perfect, not easy.
Producing championship quality lumber is not an easy process, but at Everwood Preserving, it's our only process. Wood treated right. Everwood offers top-notch pressure-treated wood for decks, outdoor structures, commercial jobs, and more that you can build your reputation on. When it comes to quality, we're on the winning team. Visit your local Everwood dealer today and discover the difference for yourself. Everwood Preserving Incorporated, the official lumber of the Alabama Crimson Tide.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC. Member FDIC.
Alabama goes with Sears, going down the lane, stepping through, kicking it out. Griffin all alone, three ball, perfect.
Bama leads Cougs Mizzou at the half, 36-34, and the sounds of the game are presented by Beatbox. The original party punch with nine delicious flavors, non-carbonated and resealable. Be the MVP of your next game day tailgate with Beatbox. Halftime stats are delivered by Assurance Financial. In less time than halftime, you can apply for a mortgage at assurancemortgage.com. Shooting percentage, Bama 45% overall, 36 from Bank First, 3 land, 5 of 6 from the foul line. For Mizzou, 52% overall, 40 from outside the arc, nothing from the stripe. Team rebounding, Bama leads at 17-14. Turnovers, Bama with 8, Tigers with 7 again at the half. Bama leads Mizzou 36-34. Let's pause 10 seconds for station ID. This is the Crimson Tide Sports Network. Back at Coleman Coliseum, Bama 36, Mizzou 34 at the half, and that does it for the Toyota Halftime Report. Second half's coming right up. This is the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
I was diagnosed with breast cancer last year and had chemo and radiation at DCH's Lewis and Faye Madison Cancer Center. I'm thankful for the support of my nurse Kate, my breast navigator Katrina, my doctors, and the whole staff. I have felt confident like I was the most important person there. Before, during, and after. Tuscaloosa's blessed to have such an excellent team at the Madison Cancer Center.
Great things are happening at DCH.
Get ready to rev up your engines and feel the excitement at Barkley Buick GMC Cadillac. We've got the perfect ride to match your style and adventure. Visit us at our showroom at Skyland Boulevard and let our friendly team help you find the vehicle of your dreams. Barkley Buick GMC Cadillac, where hometown pride and unbeatable deals collide. Drive with passion with Barkley. Visit us today or check us out online at BarkleyGMC.com. Barkley makes it easy.
Adoption of teens from foster care is a topic not enough people know about, and we're here to change that. I'm April Dinwiddie, host of the new podcast, Navigating Adoption, presented by Adopt US Kids. Each episode brings you compelling real-life adoption stories told by the families that live them with commentary from experts. Visit adoptuskids.org/podcast or subscribe to Navigating Adoption, presented by Adopt US Kids. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services Administration for Children and Families and the Ad Council.
Tom has been a teacher for over 40 years. One day, I think one of the students had asked the question and he didn't remember the answer. And I also noticed that he was letting his class out earlier than they were supposed to let out. I was really starting to worry.
Levi and I talked about how it would change our lives, but he was there beside me.
When something feels different, it could be Alzheimer's. Now is the time to talk. Visit alz.org/ourstories to learn more. A message from the Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council.
This has been the Toyota Halftime Report. Visit your local Toyota dealers or explore Toyota.com today. No matter your destination, Toyota goes with you. Toyota, let's go places. The second half is just moments away. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide, what to look for in the second half is presented by Marathon. Marathon is here to keep you and your team fueled on and off the court because we're driven together. Bama's up 2 against Mizzou, 36-34. Tom Stipe, Chris Stewart, Bryan Passink, Roger Hoover, BP. Bama was up double digits, but Missouri kind of crept back in.
Yeah, Alabama turned the ball over too many times and didn't get stops late. This Missouri team is a dangerous three-point shooting team. They've only been shooting 25% from three the last 5-6 games of the season. They're 4-for-10 here in the first half. They got loose and knocked down a couple late. Alabama was up double digits, but a late run for the Missouri Tigers, and they are right back in this game.
Alabama enjoying the 36-34 advantage at intermission as the second half is just about set to get underway. The Tide somewhat in control of this one at 33-32, up by 11, but then Missouri able to finish strong and make it a two-point game at 36-34 at intermission.
And I don't think it was an accident that Missouri was able to come back with Mark Sears in the Alabama locker room. Didn't see exactly what happened. He went off the floor during a timeout, didn't seem to have any issues, but went right into the Alabama locker room with athletic trainer Clark Holder, and apparently has a little bit of an ankle issue, maybe retaped it. He went through halftime warm-ups. Looks like he's favoring that ankle just a little bit, but he's back out there, and hopefully he can be effective.
Estrada, Sears, Pringle, Griffin, and Nelson, the five on the floor to start half number two. Same five that started the game, actually, for both sides as play resumes. Here's Sears with it, getting it into the lane, getting the basket off the glass and in. He went around Vanover and was able to lay it up beyond his 7'5 height and able to get it to go to give Bama a four-point lead.
Good start for Mark Sears, but he is favoring that left ankle on the defensive end.
Bates looking left and will feed it off to Carter. Carter stopping on the block, a bounce pass to Vanover, who slams it in for two.
I don't think he jumped.
I don't think he did either. Didn't need to. 38-36, Bama by a bucket. Missouri led at 8-5. That was their last lead, actually at 10-8. Bama will swing it around to Nelson in the far corner. Nelson picks up the dribble, needs help, gives it off to Sears. Mark trying to shake free, throws a bounce pass to Nelson, who will work against the defender. Pump fake twice, spins, looks, throws it outside. Estrada, all on three, no good. Nelson, though, out hustling everybody to the corner to save it, and then throws it off the leg of Carter out of bounds to keep the possession for Alabama.
Can't ask for a better look. Aaron Estrada all by himself at the three-point line, not able to knock it down. Offensive rebound by Alabama, and Grant Nelson throws it off Carter.
So Alabama with the basketball on the baseline. It's Estrada to inbound it. Carter face guarding him as the pass is thrown, and Nelson deflects it to Sears. Now Estrada driving, stepping through, shooting with the left hand and scoring.
He's got such great pace to his game. The initial explosiveness, but then when he got around the basket, a little Euro sidestep, slowed down, let the shot blocker go by, and finished off the rim.
East drives underneath the basket, but he went too far underneath. He stepped on the baseline, and Alabama will get possession back up four with 18:28 to go.
Nice job defensively by Grant Nelson. Not a lot of contact, but just enough to force East out of bounds.
Here's Sears with it, working against the defender Bates. Sears getting into the elbow, had it poked away, got it back, flips up the shot that wouldn't drop, and Vanover is able to claim it above everybody. Now East with the basketball. East working off of the screen, fires it over, now into the corner. They go with it to Honor. Nick Honor with the dribble, throws it to Vanover, who has it in the corner. Vanover to Bates, spinning, shooting, off the glass, misses, and the foul's going to be whistled on Alabama's Grant Nelson.
Tamar Bates, the transfer from Indiana, a lot like several of these Missouri players, made some tough shots in the first half. That one will defend it, a little bit of contact, but Bates will go to the line.
Dennis Gates upset with something with Joe Lindsay as the first free throw is made by Bates. I don't think he was upset with Lindsay. I think he's upset with A.J. Desai. 40-37, second free throw up and good. We got a two-point game again. So Alabama in a fight here with a Missouri team that's 8-8 overall, 0-3 in the league. This is, frankly, what we expected. Here is Sears with the dribble, working between the circles. Goes left, plays off the screen from Pringle. A bounce pass to Estrada. Getting into the lane, flips up the shot, got it to go, and he's fouled. And Estrada slow to get up. I think he took a punch to the gut there inadvertently, but gingerly he gets up, but he will go to the line to try to convert the and one.
Smart play by Aaron Estrada. His man was not allowing him to come back and get the ball, which is what he initially wanted to do. Beautiful backdoor pass from Mark Sears. Takes the contact. Looked like the defense, if they weren't set, they were close to it, but may have been inside the restricted area and a chance for a three-point play.
Able to knock down the free throw. Alabama 6 of 7 from the charity stripe. Missouri's made both of their attempts in the ball game. Team fouls even at 1 apiece here in the second half of play, early in half number two. 17-39 and ticking. Time left. here in the second half as Honor brings it over on the right side. Catch and shoot three from Carter. Rattles out, no good. Rebounded by Griffin. Gives it ahead now to Sears. Mark back to Griffin, top of the arc. Driving, stopping, backing it out. Playing off of a screen. Works away from trouble. Throws it down low to Pringle. He'll spin, he'll shoot, he'll miss. Tip, no good. Nelson in the rebound claimed by Butler for Mizzou. Running downhill will be East. He'll throw it into the left corner. The three ball is up and good from Nick Honor, and it's a two-point game. 43-41, Alabama by a bucket with 17 minutes to play.
That's a mistake. Foul on Missouri as Aaron Estrada tried to drive, but that's a mistake from Grant Nelson in the corner. Nick Honor, the best three-point shooter on this Missouri team, was all by himself, and Grant played him for the drive instead of as a shooter. Had enough room to get it off, and Honor knocks down his third three of the game.
Yeah, he's a 39% three-point shooter on the year coming in. As we'll see East check out and Anthony Robinson come back in to replace him with 17 minutes to go. Bama's got the ball, but only a two-point lead, 43-41. Sears around to Griffin, throws it in the corner. Estrada, three, five. Boy, he's had a nice game, hasn't he?
He has played extremely well, well executed underneath, out-of-bounds play to get the downstream on Estrada, who brought the ball in, able to catch it in the corner and knock it down.
Left side, Carter, trying to spin baseline, works against Nelson, muscles his way in, reverse layup, rolls off, rebounded Nelson. Grant throws the outlet to Estrada. Aaron will let traffic go by, feeds it over on the left side to Ryland Griffin, who will bring it to the top of the arc. Ryland picks up his dribble, needs help, feeds it over to Estrada. Back to Griffin, top of the arc, deep three, no good. Rebound controlled by Mizzou. It's Butler giving it off to Otter. Left side now on the drive is Carter. Swings a pass, far corner. Fates knocks it home, and Missouri is back to within two once again. 46-44, Bama by two with 16 minutes to play. Near turnover by the Tide, but Estrada able to save it. Hurries into the front court, goes downhill, swings it over. Griffin fakes a three, gets into the paint, spins, looks, gives it off. Pringle, nice pass, great catch inside by Nelson, and he gets mugged, and he'll go to the line to shoot two when we come back. 15-47 to play, a good one between Bama and Mizzou. It's 46-44, Alabama with a lead at home on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime, the choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Tide fans, Golden Flake Snacks have been a proud partner with the Tide family for 66 years. The South's original potato chip, Golden Flake Snacks are delicious fan favorites because they're crafted from traditional Southern recipes. From crispy, perfectly flavored potato chips to light and airy pork rinds and fluffy, cheesy cheese puffs. Share Golden Flake Snacks with your Tide family and friends. Simple Southern goodness. That's Golden Flake.
Tonight's game is presented by Mercedes-Benz. The vehicles are all electric. The feeling is all Mercedes. 15-47 to go in the ballgame. Bama's up two, 46-44 over Mizzou. We think Coke Zero Sugar is the best Coke ever. It's a bold statement because it's got that irresistible taste to back it up. Too bad you can't taste with your ears because Coke Zero Sugar truly is amazing. Taste it for yourself. Roger Hoover. Amazing in and of himself.
Well, thank you so much, Tom. Right now, Coach Oates talking about effort once again, talking about how you have to play hard to beat good teams like Missouri. So far, the scoring all even at 10 between the Crimson Tide and the Tigers in the second half. But again, the talk that pretty much all throughout this game has been energy and effort for this Alabama team in the huddle, Bryan.
Yeah, and Nato's talked about it the last few days that this Missouri team is dangerous. And one of the reasons why is they get up a lot of threes, they play with pace. They've shot the ball poorly in their last five games, just 25% from the three-point line over the last five games, and a season low coming into this one, and an overtime loss against South Carolina. But right now, Missouri, 6 for 13 from the three-point line, 46%. They're feeling it. Alabama not able to get to open shooters, and they are in a fight with a tough Missouri team.
Alabama breaking its huddle with, once again, Mark Sears, which is, again, a good sign since he didn't play the last few minutes of the first half because of an apparent ankle injury. Probably just rolled it earlier, but since he's back out there. But he's joined by Latrell Reitzel, Grant Nelson, Aaron Estrada, and Nick Pringle.
And Mark, it doesn't look full speed to me. It looks like he's favoring that ankle. Able to score on the first possession, but not that normal explosiveness. Maybe it'll get loose here in the second half, and he'll get back to the guy that right now is the front runner for SEC Player of the Year.
Driving down the lane, got knocked to the deck, and the foul on Missouri's Jordan Butler will give Bama possession underneath. Tell you what, you play Mississippi State and then Missouri, you are going to feel it for a few days, and Bama thankfully playing on Tuesday, you get the extra day to recover before we go to Knoxville. Estrada to inbound it, throws it into Sears out high. 15:35 to play as Nelson gets it inside. Pump fake shot, missed. Rebound tip back into the hands of Nelson, who lays it in. Pringle had kept it alive, but it was Nelson who benefited, and Alabama leads it by four. Honor with the basketball far side. Honor with a dribble, working against Sears. Honor trying to play off the screen. Still has it far side. Nelson defending him now on the switch. He'll dump it into the low post. Carrillero, who will swing a pass all the way left side. Butler for three, rims out. Rebound, though, goes into the hands of a Tiger. And going up and getting fouled is Robinson. That's a tough break there, Bryan, as everybody boxed out for Bama, but nobody went to get the basketball, and Missouri was able to benefit.
Yeah, got to do both. Block out and then go after it. Alabama did one and not the other. The result, an offensive rebound from Missouri. And Robinson will go to the line for two.
So Robinson shooting the first of two shots. 2 points in the game. Make it three now as he hits his first free throw attempt. Mo Diabati's going to check in, and Pringle will check out. Diabati played 3 minutes in the first half, a couple of rebounds and a steal.
Plays with energy and toughness, and that is what Alabama needs right now.
Free throw missed, and Aaron Estrada got hit in the face accidentally, but it'll be a foul on Mizzou, and I believe that's going to be on Aiden Shaw. His first 15 foul on Mizzou. Alabama's been whistled for two fouls so far this half.
Alabama just a couple away from the bonus. Would love to get in the bonus quick and get to the line. Alabama, the best free throw shooting team in the SEC.
Crimson Tide knocking down 78% of their free throws overall and 77% in conference play as Estrada circles away from trouble, hesitates, gets into the paint, gives it back out to Sears. Mark, let's fly from three. That one's short, and the ball goes out of bounds. Sears was claiming that it was touch. Nate Oates in the ear of Steven Anderson, the referee. Steven Gonzalez is our athletics communications contact for basketball, although he may not contact me anymore after I made that mistake. 14:23 and ticking. Time left to play second half. Bama up by three, but Missouri with the basketball. Robinson on the drive, cut off by Estrada. Gives it off to Carrillero, who lost it. Goes to the deck, though, to pick up the loose ball. Then stripped away by Diabati. Now a tie-up's going to be called, and the arrow will favor the Tigers. But Mo Diabati went in and just snatched that one away from the Missouri player initially.
Yeah, great effort by Alabama getting on the floor for the loose ball, and Diabati doing what he does, providing energy, toughness, getting on the floor for that one.
So Missouri will inbound it underneath after the arrow favored them. And Dennis Gates will make a change, getting east into the game before he can inbound the ball. And he'll take the place of Nick Honor.
Need to get the crowd back in this one.
Yeah.
It was electric in the first half, midway through it, but not much energy on the floor or in the building here in the second half for Alabama.
Since Missouri made that run late first half, Bama's energy and that of the Coleman faithful has been lacking as the Tigers will drive. They get it to the baseline. Shot blocked by Nelson. Maybe that'll get him going. A little word or two for Robinson, and they're going to tee him up. Grant blocked the shot of Anthony Robinson and then barked at him a little bit. And Steven Anderson teed him up. Brian, does that tee get called if we don't have anything take place in the first half?
Probably not, and also right in front of the Missouri bench. I don't know what he said. It didn't look like a whole lot, and maybe that will get this crowd back in the game.
Yeah. Again, may not work to Missouri's benefit, even if they make both free throws, as East does indeed knock them both down. But Bama will have the ball.
And that was a great defensive play by Grant Nelson. Anderson trying to go past him. Grant able to stay with him, get the block shot. He's top 10 in the SEC in block shots. It was a great defensive play, but unfortunately got called for the tee.
Nate Oates just told Grant Nelson, don't do less than intelligent things, but he said it in a far more colorful way. Here is Bama with the basketball, getting it front court. Diabate to Nelson for the lay-in and two.
Alabama handled the full court or half court trap of Missouri. Diabate with not a perfect pass, but Grant Nelson able to catch it instead of throwing it down, just lays it in.
3-point Bama lead. They'll drive it right side, will the Tigers. Then back it out high and bring it all the way to the left wing. East giving it up. Carrillero, top of the arc. Carrillero looking, pivoting, giving it back to East with 7 on the shot clock. East driving right. East cut off in the corner. 3-2, a heave at 1. And it's a shot clock violation, but Bama had already started possession the other way. Here comes Sears. Sears to Nelson. Hands it off to Abadi. Moe pivots, looks, back to Nelson again. Nelson says, get out of the way. I got a mismatch. Gives it off Sears. Near side. D3. And the head has come off. Timeout on the floor. 12:48 to play. Bama 53. Missouri 47 on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Victor deployed for the first time to Afghanistan in 2003. He sustained a moderate traumatic brain injury. One of the most important elements of caregiving is taking care of yourself.
For many military veteran caregivers, their caregiving journey starts earlier in life and lasts longer. Visit aarp.org/caregiving for a free military veteran's guide to navigate your caregiving journey and better care for your loved one and yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Don't you wish your life came with a warning app?
Stop. That dog does not want to be petted.
A heads up before something bad happens.
You should not send that text.
Uh-oh. Life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. With early diagnosis and a few healthy changes, you can reverse prediabetes and prevent or delay type 2 diabetes. To learn your risk, take the one-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its prediabetes awareness partners.
.48 to go in the ball game. Bama up 53-47 over Mizzou. An important reminder to all Crimson Tide fans, stay up to date with all recommended vaccinations. Flu season is here. COVID-19 continues, so don't wait. Vaccinate. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM to learn more. Across the way to Roger Hoover.
All right, the Crimson Tide are talking about how this is the time to really make a run and get some separation from Missouri with that three-pointer by Sears, now back up by 6. But speaking of Mark Sears, he is getting treatment from Clark Holto, the athletic trainer, on that left ankle really all throughout this timeout. He's still sitting on a stool, so it looks like he will be coming back in this ball game again. He's getting treatment during each timeout so far here in the second half.
Well, good to see Mark Sears in this game. I'm not sure that he's 100% right now with that ankle. At 100%, Mark Sears, I think, right now is the SEC Player of the Year. Maybe I'm at 60, 70, 80%, whatever he is, he's still really, really good and needs to be on the floor. He's made plays here in the second half, the floater to start the half, big three right there. But it's been the defense of Alabama the last few possessions. Missouri has not scored a field goal in almost 3.5 minutes. The crowd's getting back in this game like they were in the first half and going to need it. This Missouri team is tough. They're dangerous. And they're desperate. They're 0-3 in the SEC. They've lost a bunch of close games. They've been right there. And when they shoot the ball well, they can beat some of the top teams in this league. They've shot it well in this game, shooting 40%, 6 for 15 from the three-point line. Alabama's got to do a good job of defending, but also defending the three-point line where Missouri's starting to feel it.
Tigers bring it front court as the crowd is indeed back in it here at Coleman Coliseum. Backing his way down, Carrillero from the right elbow gets into the lane, walks, great defense. Latrell Reitzel almost looked like he pulled the chair out from under him, Bryan.
Yeah, Latrell Reitzel, really good perimeter defender, but also a veteran, and he's strong. Alabama's guards sometimes get matched up on opposing teams' interior players, which happened right there to Latrell Reitzel. But Alabama's perimeter players really good on the defensive end, both outside and in.
Bama works it inside. Nelson, great pass. Diabati off the glass. Got it to go. Oh, Mo got it to drop on a great feed from Nelson, and the Tide leads by 8.
What a pass from Grant Nelson, and the finish, the hang time by Mo Diabati.
Bounce pass blocked by Nelson, but it's called a kick ball. They threw it off his leg, which is apparently dinged up a little bit. He's going to exit, and Nick Pringle will come in to replace him. We got something big with Nelson, just something that hurt for the moment.
Well, it is rough in this league. You got Mark Sears favoring that left ankle. Grant Nelson limping to the Alabama bench.
Carter trying to shake free against Pringle. Gives it off. Carrillero driving, stopping, looking. Bounce pass inside. Pump fake shot. Good for two on a nice move by Tamar Bates. Bama lead down to 6, 55-49 with 11:44 to play. Sears off the screen, going right, working away from a double team, tries to step through it, does, got fouled, and he'll have the ball. Bates a little more contact than would have been like through the whistle. I think Latrell Reitzel came over and said something. Everybody play nice. We got things going our way. We want to keep it that way as we've come to another media timeout with 11:37 to go. 55-49, Bama leading Mizzou by 6 here on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Alabama Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight. The moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Power for a better Alabama.
T-Mobile is proud to bring 5G to hometowns across the SEC, and T-Mobile is a proud partner of the Crimson Tide. Bama's up 55-49, 11:37 to go in the ball game, and Roger Hoover
I think the lid's going to come off this place if Bama gets another run going.
Yeah, that'd certainly be good. Everybody kind of taking a deep breath at the moment for the Crimson Tide. Most of the conversation in this last huddle was all about defense for Alabama and what the Crimson Tide need to do to maintain a six-point edge. So, again, everybody was pretty calm after making their way back to the Crimson Tide huddle, back to the Missouri huddle. Now it's just to focus on the defensive end of the floor more than anything for Alabama, Brian.
And Alabama's done a much better job on that end of the floor. Finally gave up a field goal, unfortunately, the last possession, but it had been almost 4 minutes since Missouri has scored at the rim, and Bama's defensive intensity has picked up. The intensity here in Coleman Coliseum has picked up, and both teams have gotten after each other, had to separate a couple of guys going into the timeout, and like we talked about earlier in this game, when that happens, officials tend to call it a little closer. That could be to Alabama's advantage, just one away from the bonus with 11:37 to play. It's been Missouri with 16 fouls. Alabama, the number one free throw shooting team in the SEC. And Missouri's had a hard time defending without fouling. They typically send their opponents to the line. Hopefully Alabama will see a lot of opportunities at the stripe the last 11 and a half minutes of this game.
Mark Sears, Aaron Estrada, Latrell Reitzel, Nick Pringle, Mo Diabate, the five on the floor for the Alabama Crimson Tide. Estrada to inbound it. Looking to get it in, does so to Diabate in the corner. Mo driving, dumps it off, all alone. Reitzel, three, in and out, no good. It was halfway down. Here comes Missouri the other way after Bama has the narrow miss. Tigers with it to the top of the arc. Carolero looking inside, gives it off to Honor. He'll dribble away from trouble, brings it to the near wing. Have to defend him on the perimeter. Honor back up top. Carolero going down the lane. Nice bounce pass and a block by Bama, but they got a piece of the arm as well of Aiden Shaw. Second on Diabate.
Nice interior defense. Nick Pringle was in pretty good position. Mo Diabate came over, tried to block it down. I think if he stays straight up and down, that's going to be a block shot, not a foul, but instead it's Missouri and Shaw to the line.
Shaw has that one pop out. Jaron Stevenson in, replacing Diabate. Rylan Griffin comes in to replace Aaron Estrada. Second free throw upcoming from Shaw. 6'8 sophomore has that one pop out. Long rebound tipped, thankfully, into the hands of Griffin, who had it knocked away from him, but Pringle picks it up, nearly has it stolen, and gives it off to Sears. Sears with it top of the circle. Sears playing off of a screen, steps back, deep three, short, and the rebound goes to the deck, but Shaw picks it up there, and now here comes Missouri again, trying to narrow what is a six-point Alabama lead. Bates driving down the lane, walk, they didn't call it. Honor with it now near side, throws it down into the post. Carolero spinning away from Sears. Double team, a bounce pass, bounces everywhere and winds up in the hands of Bates. Kicks it into the corner, open look, east three ball, hit the top of the glass, and Bama saved it. Now it's Reitzel working his way through traffic. Weaves his way into the front court, gets into the lane, kicks it in the corner to Griffin. Ryland, a nice catch on the high pass, gets into the paint himself, spins, has it stripped, nearly stolen, out of bounds, touch last by Missouri. Boy, you got to be tough with the basketball on both ends of the floor.
And Alabama was right there. Latrell Reitzel gets the rebound, dribbles through traffic. Rylan Griffin in great position. Nice defensive play to knock it out of bounds for Missouri.
Stevenson tied up at the corner. Terrible pass, throws it away. Now here's Bates going down the lane. Steps through, blocked by Nelson, but that's goaltending. Goaltending, the call on Grant Nelson as he pinned it against the glass. And Bates got popped somewhere along the way as well.
Oh, what a mistake. Jaron Stevenson trapped in the corner, just kind of a lazy pass. Needed to either get a timeout or throw it off the defender. You can't throw a pass like that against a good defensive team. Missouri able to get the easy steal and lay it.
Bama up by four with 9:55 to go. Here's Sears with it. Mark working left, goes down the lane. Step through, tough shot, wouldn't go, but he got fouled and he'll go to the line to shoot two. What a great move by Sears. Almost finished it off for a chance at an and one. Instead, he'll go to the line for a pair of free throws.
Again, playing on a hurt ankle, twisted his ankle in the first half. He's done some nice things, but favoring it, a little short on a couple of jump shots.
First free throw up and good.
A lot of times when a shooter has a leg injury or ankle, it impacts their shot more so than if something happens to your upper body. Mark Sears able to connect on two free throws right there.
Got him to go, and Bama leads it by six once again, 57-51. Honor with it, front court for the Tigers. Gives it off to Robinson. Robinson dribbling to the right wing. Now surveying the floor with the dribble alive, picks it up, gives it off to Carrillero. Carrillero spinning into the lane, nice move to his right and got it to go off the glass for two.
That was too easy. Nice play against the freshman Stevenson.
Now here's Sears weaving through traffic. Gets fouled, no whistle, loses the handle, driving in. Missing the dunk was Carrillero, and Bama comes the other way. They got numbers. Griffin driving to the rim, got fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Boy, Alabama thought they were going to go to the free throw line. Mark Sears tried to split the double team, doesn't get the call. Missouri with a two-on-one. Bama able to get back and force a difficult shot. It was Jaron Stevenson at least challenging the dunk. Still should have been one Missouri made. Rylan Griffin takes it inside and gets to the line. One and one coming up. Or is this two?
This will be two shots. It's only the 18th foul, but he was definitely in the act of shooting and got the free throw to go as Bama is now 9 of 10 from the stripe. Stevenson out, Pringle back in to replace him. 58-53 Alabama at the moment with 9:07 to go.
Mentioned some of the injuries. Mark Sears on a bad ankle. Grant Nelson went to the Alabama bench limping, and Rylan Griffin goes to the free throw line holding his elbow.
But he hit both free throws, and he gives Alabama the 59-53 advantage. Clock moving. Hits the 9-minute mark right now. Robinson, front court for the Tigers. Dribbles right, gives it off to Honor. Honor dribbling to his left, gets to the elbow, gets into the paint. Pump fake, bounce pass over on his right to Carter. Carter works underneath the basket. Spins, shoots, scores. Tough move inside from Noah Carter. 6'6", 235, he is tough to contain. Here comes Bama the other way. Ball knocked away on the pass attempt by Griffin and controlled by Missouri. They can cut into a four-point Bama lead. Carter giving it off to East, who will direct traffic. East with 8:20 to go, giving it back to Carter right side. Backing his way underneath. Stops, shoots, misses this time. He wanted a foul call, no whistle, and Bama comes the other way. Sears gets it into the front court. Mark directing traffic. Sears playing off of a screen. Now a double team. He tries to step through it. They're going to call a tie-up, and the arrow is going to favor Alabama. Timeout on the floor. 7:58 to go. 59-55. Bama with a lead here against Missouri on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Hey, so what's a great way to spread awareness that driving high is illegal everywhere? A catchy song, of course.
You can't run, but you can't drive high. You can't run, but you can't drive high.
Friendly reminder, don't drive high. If you feel different, you drive different. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
7:58 to go in the ballgame. Bama's up 4, 59-55, and Coleman over Mizzou. Best move of the game is presented by Old Dominion Freight Line. Old Dominion Freight Line works hard to be the best in the game and is a proud partner of the Crimson Tide. BP, your nomination for the best move of the game.
Well, there have been several from Aaron Estrada. He's leading the way for Alabama with 15 points, 6 for 11 from the field. He's got 7 rebounds and 4 assists. A couple of steals to go with that. Aaron Estrada playing well, just needs some help right in this second half against a Missouri team that is better than advertised. We thought we would get Missouri's best shot. They're 0-3 in the league. They've had a bunch of close losses this year. They went to Rupp, were in that game late. Ultimately, Kentucky gets the win. They were within a couple of possessions of beating Kansas at Kansas earlier in the season, coming off an overtime loss against a good South Carolina team. So this Missouri team playing well, and when they're making threes, very dangerous, and they've knocked them down here in this one.
Crimson Tide trying to get to 4-0 in Southeastern Conference play. They will be on the road Saturday afternoon. It's a early tip for that ball game. They have now set it for a 1 o'clock Central start. That means we'll be on the air at noon Central from Thompson Bowling Arena. ESPN2 will televise it nationally, and then ESPN will have our matchup against Auburn on the 24th. So coming up next week, Auburn and Alabama meeting for the first of two times. It's the Tuscaloosa matchup, 6:30 here at Coleman Coliseum. Make sure you are in your spot for that one. Alabama's inbound coming from Estrada, throws it backcourt to Latrell Reitzel, who will bring it ahead against the Missouri man-to-man. Reitzel dribbles left side, pivots, needs help. Still needs help. Gives it off to Griffin. Top of the arc. Catch and shoot three. Bottom. That's as confident a stroke as we've seen from Rylan Griffin.
He was ready to shoot. Reitzel didn't have anywhere to go with it. Missouri was denying the ball to Aaron Estrada. Rylan Griffin pops up to the top of the key and knocks it down.
7-point Bama lead. Honor giving it off. Swing pass goes all the way across the Bama D to Robinson. Now back out they go to East. Crowd on its feet here at Coleman. East with it, driving, dishing, Honor with it, near side, trying to go baseline, trying to initiate contact, tough shot, no good, rebound grabbed inside, and shot missed by Aiden Shaw.
Alabama not able to secure the defensive rebound, and big reason why Nick Honor was able to get inside. Alabama a little bit of a scramble situation, didn't get block out assignments, and close to a three-point play. Grant Nelson got him, and Shaw go to the line for two.
Shaw to shoot the first. 0 for 2 on previous trips. Oh, my goodness. Better to be lucky than good.
And that was the ugliest one of them all, as it hits in between the backboard and the back part of the rim, just kind of dies and ultimately goes in.
And that one rattles in. 62-57 with 7:08 to play. Bama with the basketball. Estrada bringing it ahead, directing traffic as Mizzou goes zone. This trip down into the corner, all alone. Reitzel, three ball, bottom. Alabama starting to heat up from Bank First. Three-point range, 9 made threes on 22 attempts, and the Tide leads it by 8.
Yeah, play zone against this Alabama team. Let guys get their feet set.
Reitzel, go to that zone, Rick. That'll work. Yeah, I know it's Dennis, but if you know, you know. On the drive, down the lane, on a reverse layup. No good, but he is fouled by Estrada. That was a little turn back the clock reference to the Ernest Shelton days.
This Missouri team has some guys that kind of bull their way to the basket. Noah Carter, 6'6", about 240. He's on the Missouri bench right now, but just able to get inside, use his physicality to get to the rim. This time it was Nick Honor who's gotten it done from the three-point line, and not the skinniest of point guards, using that bulk to go inside.
Look, He is a tremendous player, so I don't want this taken as disrespect, but he looks like the guy in a pickup game at the gym that you think you can take, and you wind up, that dude has just schooled me. Free throw, whose dad is that? Free throw was missed. Bama claims it, and here comes Griffin into front court. Griffin working left, almost walked, but feeds Nelson. Gets a return feed. Griffin now for three. Oh, he's heating up. Rylan Griffin has made two of the last three from deep. Dennis Gates not happy with Joe Lindsay, but Nate Oates is more than happy with Rylan Griffin. 6:19 to play, and Alabama leads it by 10, just one shy of their biggest first half lead at 11 points.
A little back-to-back 6-0 run for Rylan Griffin, making plays on the offensive end, this time over number 75, because he's 7'5", the center for Missouri, stepping out, not able. Connor Vanover not able to get the contest. Rylan Griffin knocks it down, his second three and his many trips. Big back-to-back baskets from Rylan.
Missouri uses its last timeout trying to slow Alabama's momentum, but also to give their head coach, Dennis Gates, to share as much disdain as he can with the officials. That was apparently a full timeout called there by Missouri, and this is really kind of their last gasp, it seems, Bryan, using that timeout, trying to rally the troops one final time. They did that in the first half, took it from 11 down to 2 at intermission. They're looking for a similar push right here.
Well, the things that Missouri has done well, even in defeat, is they create turnovers. Alabama's got to be strong with the ball. And when they've shot it well, they've been tough to beat. They just have not shot the ball well the last five games coming into this one. They have here tonight in this one, shooting 38% from the three-point line. So they're a confident team that can get hot. Alabama's got to continue to defend and defend the three-point line offensively. Take care of the ball. Keep attacking. Alabama in the bonus. The best free-throw shooting team in the SEC needs to be there often here the last 6 minutes, 19 seconds of this game.
Missouri will have possession. Alabama will again have Estrada, Reitzel, Griffin, Nelson, and Nick Pringle on the floor. Missouri with it front court. Bates to the elbow. Carrillero, he'll pivot. He'll dribble left a couple of times. A backdoor look to Bates. Shot blocked by Nick Pringle, but they'll call him for a foul. Wow. Pringle thought he got it clean.
Because he did.
Oh,
what a play from Nick Pringle.
First personal on Nick Pringle, and we're not positive it happened right there. Bryan, did he get him on the way down? The block clean up high, but the follow through got him on top of the head,
man,
baby.
That's a great block.
Okay, I just asked.
I've seen it three times from different angles. Great block by Nick Pringle. He's been huge in this game. Only played 6 minutes in Starkville, had five fouls. This one, he's been so effective, double digits. And this one, great defensive play, but unfortunately, Missouri goes to the line and converts.
Yeah, Bates hit them both, and the reason they got that call is because Dennis Gates had called timeout to chew on the officials just prior to that.
That stuff works.
It does indeed. Latrell Reitzel trying to work against Bates, who's very vocal and physical. Now it's Nelson going baseline. He draws the foul before the reverse layup went in for two. And that foul on Abe Shaw.
19th foul for Missouri, 1-1 coming up for Grant Nelson. Kind of wish they hadn't called that one, made the reverse lay-in after the call was made. But Alabama spreading the floor, attacking the rim, and that's one thing that Nate Oates wants to see more out of Grant Nelson, and that's attacking the rim. Did that maybe a little more effectively earlier in the season. He's gotten away from it. Did a nice job on that possession.
My mistake. 1-3, Carrillero, not 2-3 in Shaw, and the front end of a 1-1, good by Nelson. Bama, really good from the stripe tonight. They have made 11 of 12, Missouri 10 of 14. Second free throw from Grant, up and good as well with 5:48 remaining.
Another rock-solid game in all areas for Grant Nelson. 9 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists.
A couple of block shots, too. Carolero with a dribble and a handoff to Carter, who goes right side. Bama leads it by 10, 70-60. 5.5 minutes to go. Right side, deep three. Carter up and good. He's a nice shooter. 12.5 per game for him, and he now will see Bama come to the other end of the floor, and I think Carter committed the foul. Nope, they're going to say it was on East, and a double technical there. A.J. Desai calling a double technical. Two players chirping at each other.
Well, they're going to call it tight, and if anybody looks at somebody, it's going to be a technical or a double technical.
35, Noah Carter,
so
his third personal
foul. Those will cancel each other out, except for the personal fouls, but it'll be
foul.
Aaron Estrada at the line in the double bonus the rest of the way. Alabama spreading Missouri out, continuing to attack, and Estrada will go to the line for two.
That's four now on Reitzel.
And that's important because Mark Sears is on the Alabama bench, not at full strength, dealing with that ankle injury.
Aaron Estrada knocks down the first of two. Yeah, when you got the double technical, no free throws involved. That's better. That's more of a y'all better behave T than anything else. Estrada hits them both, and Alabama leads it by 9 with 5:20 to go. Honor getting it front court. Going across the lane, kicks it back to Carter. Fakes a three, drives in, goes back to Honor. His three is up and good. They've made two in a row from that spot with two different players. Bama's lead down to 6 with 5 minutes to go. Here's Griffin with it front court. Gives it off to Estrada. Estrada driving, getting into the lane. Whips a pass into the corner. Reitzel, the trail. Back to Estrada for three. In and out, no good. Rebounded. Nelson lays it in. Great rebound, Grant Nelson. He's in double-figure scoring now with 11 to go with his 8 rebounds. Now it's Honor trying to back his way down against Estrada. Spins around and gets into the lane. Wild shot off the glass. No, but he is fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot a pair.
Once again, just using his strength to get the ball inside. Almost had a 3-point play, just kind of threw it up there. Off the glass, a little strong. Nick Honor knocked down a big three. This time a chance to go to the line, cut into the Alabama lead. Good offense on the Alabama end. Aaron Estrada's played so well, ends up with a wide open 3-point look. Grant Nelson, another rebound, offensive putback.
Honor misses the first. As Shaw comes in to replace Carolero. Second free throw up. That one's good. And Bama's lead is cut back down to 7. 74-67 with 4:25 to play. Nelson with the basketball for Bama. Goes to his left. Gets cut off and backs it out beyond the arc. Thought about a shot. Instead feeds Estrada. Aaron on the drive. Gets into the lane. Needs help. Throws it out to Griffin. Ryland being defended by East. Griffin working top of the arc. Lets it fly. Oh, is he hot? Oh. Ryland, a little something-something to his game tonight, boy. He has got 16 points, 4 of 6 from deep. Carter looking, gives it off to Bates, left side. Bates thought about it, dribbles right, has it top of the arc, goes down the lane, had it knocked away. Griffin with the steal, gives it off to Reitzel. Latrell front court. Latrell working left, getting into the lane. Give it back to Ryland. He does. Griffin, step back three.
Oh!
It is his world. We are just living in it, baby. Red, smoking, hot. Ryland Griffin, 19 as Bama leads it by 13. 3:22 to go. Otter fouled, they say, by Estrada, bringing us to a media timeout. The Ryland Griffin Show coming out of nowhere as Bama leads it 80-67 with 3:18 to play here on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Hey, folks, Bob Baumhauer here. We're extremely proud that Baumhauer's Victory Grill has been serving Alabama for 43 legendary years. Our motto is legendary fun, legendary food, and we strive to make every dining experience a special one for all of our guests. Our menu features delicious, always fresh, and scratch-made in-house recipes. And, of course, our award-winning wings and sauces. And don't forget, our happy hour and halftime daily specials cannot be beat. Baumhauer's Victory Grill, legendary fun, legendary food.
During the pandemic, we put a lot on hold. One of the things missed may have been keeping up with our regularly scheduled vaccinations. Hi, I'm Dallas Turner.
And I'm Rodell Williams. We're here to remind everyone across the state to protect the entire Bama community by staying up to date with all recommended vaccinations.
Flu season is coming, and COVID-19 continues to affect our community. So don't wait. Vaccinate.
Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM to learn more about how you can stay safe and up to date on vaccinations for you and your children.
Stay safe and roll time.
Bama's up on Mizzou 80-67 in a red smoking hot Coleman Coliseum, too. Tonight's game between Alabama and Mizzou is presented by Mercedes-Benz. The vehicles are all electric. The feeling is all Mercedes. Be sure and stay tuned after the game for the Regents postgame show with Bama coach Nate Oates. Don't forget you can get your University of Alabama Visa check card from Regents. Visit Regents.com/GoBama to order yours today. Roger Hoover is on the Bama bench.
Well, a really positive Crimson Tide huddle, especially looking at the defensive end of the floor. Nate Oates has pointed out that a lot of Missouri's points in the last stretch only came at the free throw line. So some good things happening defensively for the Crimson Tide. Now the message is simple. Box out to finish out this ball game, Bryan, with 3:18 to go.
Yeah, and this is a hot Missouri team. Thankfully, it's been a hot Ryland Griffin. He's got 19 points on 6-for-8, shooting 5-for-7 from the three-point line. And the last couple have been really well defended by Missouri, but Ryland Griffin is hot. He's feeling it. He's looking for a shot. Should have been probably a foul against Missouri on the dribble drive, but Ryland was fine with it as he just stepped back and hit another contested three. Missouri is playing well. They're shooting it well. But Alabama right now 60% from the field in the second half. And just under that, 58%, 7-for-12 from the three-point line since halftime. Alabama overall 12-for-26 from deep, getting it done where they typically do, and that's the three-point line.
Alabama breaks its huddle with the flamethrower, Ryland Griffin, Grant Nelson, Aaron Estrada, Nick Pringle, and Latrell Reitzel.
How about the game of Grant Nelson? He was so good defensively against Mississippi State. 9 points, 9 rebounds. Did a terrific job on one of the best centers in the country. And Tolu Smith, another solid game on both ends of the floor for Grant Nelson. 11 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists, couple of blocks. Making things happen on both ends of the floor.
At the stripe, Honor hits the first. He'll have another one upcoming. Nick Honor listed at 5'10", 200 pounds. All muscle. Free throw up, free throw good. He got them both. And he makes it an 80-69 ball game with 3:15 to go. Bama basketball, it's Estrada bringing it up with Honor defending him. Now they'll drop back into a zone. Near side, Estrada with a dribble. Gives it off to Nelson at the elbow. He'll get into the paint. He gets fouled. Carrillero just fouled out. Two shots upcoming as that is team foul number 12 on the visitors.
Yeah, I understand Dennis Gates trying to change things up defensively. Alabama's, we talked about, shooting 61% in the second half. They go to a zone in Alabama for a team that doesn't play zone. They don't see much zone in practice because this is a man-to-man team. Boy, they handle it so well. Getting the ball to the high post. They run some really great stuff against zone defenses and went to Grant Nelson at the high post. Now the free throw line area, pump fake, attack the basket, understanding time. score in the foul situation. Alabama at any Missouri fouls going to line for two. Brent Nelson able to take the contact, and Bama will get back to the free throw line where they've been really good in this game.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Crimson Tide Sports Network. Grant Nelson hits the first of two free throws for Alabama. Senior's got a dozen points, make it 13 as he hits them both. And Alabama now leads it by 13 with under 3 minutes to go.
Alabama 16 for 17 from the line tonight.
Honor gives it off right side to Carter. Back to Honor, deep three, no good. Rebounded by Griffin, and Ryland will now give it off to Estrada. Griffin with four boards to go with his 19 points. Estrada, 17 points, 7 boards, 4 assists, drives down the lane, off the glass and in. Boy, he deserved that bucket. He's got 19, and Alabama leads it by 15, their biggest margin.
Smart play from Aaron Estrada, driving to the side that Ryland Griffin standing on. They're not leaving Ryland, and Aaron able to get to the rim.
Bates knocks it down from 15. And the Bama leads down to 13. Missouri tried to steal the inbounds, knocked it away, but out of bounds. And possession will belong to the Crimson Tide.
Alabama 12 for 26 from the three-point line, and it's been Ryland Griffin leading the way. He's attempted 7 from deep. He's made 5. The majority of those coming in the second half, and as a point guard, which is where Aaron Estrada is playing right now. Dribble at Ryland Griffin, and you're going to be free to the basket.
Pringle driving inside. Pump fake, spins off the glass. No rebound, fought for. Reitzel gets it, but he gets fouled on the play. That was a wild move. I don't know how Pringle got that shot off, let alone coming very close to making it.
Not a high percentage shot from Nick Pringle, who typically only attempts high percentage shots. Usually he's looking to dunk right there. Goes up, double pump, underhand, but got it up on the backboard. And Alabama with an offensive rebound back at the free throw line. Trell Reitzel's starting to play his best basketball. Couldn't come at a better time for this Alabama team.
Free throw up and good from Latrell.
So with 19 in the game against Mississippi State. Not going to get quite there, but he's been effective in this one.
Hit them both, and Alabama leads at 86-71 once again. Honor trying to shake free. Let's fly from deep. Wouldn't go. Rebound tipped around. They're going to call a foul on Grant Nelson as he was battling with Noah Carter for the loose ball. Four now on Grant. He and Reitzel both on the floor with four fouls, along with Estrada, all three of them now in that spot. Carter. First one up and good. 86-72 is the Bama advantage with a minute 47 to go. Bama fans who were fantastic to show up in large numbers tonight, and they had an impact on this one. Many of them, though, filing for the exits. Looking like home team can get it done from this point forward as Carter does hit them both from Missouri. It's an 86-73 score.
Yeah, great crowd considering the weather situation in this state over the last few days, but especially the students.
Yeah. Huge turnout from them as Reitzel brings it into the front court, unloads it to Estrada. Bama trying to play keep away. Gives it off to Griffin, now to Pringle, now to the cutter Nelson. Grant will kick it out to Estrada. Left alone, his three is up and no good. Rebound tipped into the hands of Griffin. Ryland says, come catch me. Put me on the free throw line. They should have. He'll step through, he'll drive in, he'll lay it in for two more.
Second chance opportunities, Ryland Griffin doing it all here tonight.
Underneath, spinning shot missed by Bates. Pringle clears the miss. And with a minute to go, Bama leads it by 15, and the Tide's got the ball. Pringle driving, hands it off to Pringle, back to Griffin, now to Reitzel for three, and he buries another bank first three. Latrell Reitzel now with 11, and it's all over but the shouting, folks. Deep three from the Tigers, missed. Rebound claimed by Estrada. He accidentally gets pushed to the deck and then is helped up by Robinson.
What a performance by this Alabama team on both ends of the floor, but especially offensively. Over 60% in the second half. 61% on 17 for 28 field goals. Some second chance opportunities and lighten it up from three. Alabama 8 for 13 in the second half. 13 for 27 overall. And this Alabama team, so fun to watch when they're getting stops out in transition, and didn't get probably as many stops as Nate Oates would have liked in the second half. Missouri, a dangerous team from the three-point line, caught fire. Made this more of a game than we wanted it to be in the second half, but the firepower of this Alabama team, just too much. The nation's number one offense, looking like it here tonight.
The guys who were on the floor, Nelson, Griffin, Reitzel, Pringle, Estrada, checking out with the exception of Aaron, who's got to make one more free throw in order to exit. Sam Walters will replace him. Davin Cosby Jr., Mo Diabati, Mo Wagi, and Jaron Stevenson already on the floor as replacements, and Estrada hits them both. He now has 21 points as he exits the game. A nice round of applause for him, and well-deserving as Sam Walters does indeed come in to replace him. Jackson Francois checks in for Missouri. I was hoping he would, just so I could say that. Here is Robinson in the front court. 2 years of high school French, and it finally paid off. Here is Robinson working to his left. Nearly broke his own ankles, trying to shake free against Diabati. Spins, tough shot. There's your one for your highlight reel.
He scored.
Jackson Francois.
He didn't go anywhere.
He did?
And he didn't shake anybody.
Nope.
But I'll give him credit. He made the shot.
He did indeed. Alabama's not going to shoot again. Final 15 seconds are going to tick away. And Alabama's going to win its fourth straight to begin Southeastern Conference play. And now sits at 12-5 overall on the season. Alabama wins it by a final score of 93-75 and strike up the band. Over Missouri. Head coach Nate Oates joining us courtside in just a matter of moments as Bama gets the victory by the final score again, 93-75. Boy, it's a lot closer ball game than that for the majority of the night, BP.
Well, it was until Rylan Griffin caught fire. This
true.
Missouri team, they came to try to win their first SEC game of the year. They've been close, losing their last one to South Carolina in overtime by two, and thought we would get Missouri's best shot. That was the case. Alabama able to do it with Mark Sears not at full speed, went out of the first half with an ankle injury. Fortunately came back in the game, made a couple of shots. Hopefully he'll be okay in that extra day rest between now and Saturday, where Bama has to make the trip to Knoxville, Tennessee to play one of the best teams in the SEC in Tennessee, but other guys were able to step up. It was Aaron Estrada with 21 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists. Latrell Reitzel, another double-digit game as he scores 13 in this one. But it was a great performance by Alabama, especially on the offensive end. That's what we expect from this Alabama team. The best offensive team in college basketball, getting it done here at home.
top offensive team in the SEC, and in our opinion, the top coach of the league joins us now as well. Coach Nate Oates, congratulations. Great win for your squad.
Yeah, I thought we had some good moments. You know, we got to figure out how to put 40 together, but we closed the game well. We did not close the first half well. Didn't think we opened first half or the second half well, but we closed well, and we've had an issue closing the last 12 minutes, so I was proud of them for doing that. So, you know, it's not easy to get SEC wins, and they gave us everything they could, and to give them a bunch of credit. But, you know, I thought they battled and fought, and they're going to get some wins in the SEC, and we were fortunate to get one tonight.
Not easy to get it done, especially, Coach, with arguably your best player on the bench for a majority of the night, Mark Sears, a little gimpy, and Riley Griffin says, don't worry, I got you.
Yeah, no, Sears sprained his ankle. He tried to give it a go. I mean, I think if it would have been a little tighter, maybe he could have kept him in there longer. But, you know, he fought, he battled. You know, he's leading scorer in the SEC. So it's nice to have him in there, but it's also nice to know we can win, you know, with some other guys stepping up. I thought, you know, Ryland went on that kind of barrage of threes there in the second half to open it up, which was huge. You know, our team knows he can play that way. We just got to get him locked in every game out. But he's been pretty locked in on defense. You know, it's just sometimes offense, it's your night, and sometimes it's not. And, you know, him and Aaron both stepped up in a big way tonight. And I mean, Ryland, that's about as efficient a game as you're going to get. He scored 21 points on 9 shot attempts. Only went to the free throw line once. You know, he's 2-2 at the line. So it's not like he was just feasting at the line. So, you know, big game, best game he's played for us here offensively for sure.
Coach, there have been a lot of reasons for fans maybe not to show up and not have an impact tonight, given the weather, and a lot of folks couldn't get here from different parts of the state. But the ones that did, man, they were loud, Coach.
Yeah, no, I thought it was great. Our student section was packed. You know, the fans that did come got super loud. You know, for a night, they're not used to this down here in Alabama with some
right.
ice on the road. So for a day like this, a night like this, I thought we had great crowd support, and showing like 11,000. So I thought that was really good.
Coach, thank you for the time. Congratulations on the win.
Appreciate it, guys. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide. Coach Nate Oates with us as his Tide does indeed roll. 93-75, improving to 12-5 on the year, 4-0 in Southeastern Conference play. When we come back, Roger Hoover will get things going on our postgame coverage. The region's postgame show comes your way next here on the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Yellowhammer Brewing is proud to sponsor the Alabama Crimson Tide. Yellowhammer Brewing has been crafting fine beers for the state of Alabama for 12 years running. Their beers include a variety of classic styles, including their latest release, Yellowhammer Gold, a light, easy-drinking American lager. These guys are local and doing great things for their community. You can find their beers at grocery stores, restaurants, and craft beer shops throughout the state. Check them out at yellowhammerbrewing.com. Make your next pint of Yellowhammer and Roll Tide.
When you're planning your next visit to Tuscaloosa, explore the upscale options available at the new AC Hotel by Marriott. Conveniently located in the heart of downtown Tuscaloosa, surrounding yourself in luxury and comfort in a spacious room with complimentary Wi-Fi, a smart TV, premium toiletries, and a plush bed, while the rooftop bar and lounge provides the best place in town to wind down after cheering the Crimson Tide to victory. AC Hotel Tuscaloosa Downtown is proud to be a preferred hotel partner of the University of Alabama Athletics.
Hi, I'm Jay Howard, an employee at BASF in Alabama. As a supervisor, I love working with a company who wins by offering great benefits to its team members. With great chemistry, anything is possible. At BASF, we create chemistry around the world through our people and our products. To join a winning team and a great place to work, visit BASF.US/Alabama. That's BASF.US/Alabama. BASF, we create chemistry.
Convenience is the name of the game at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites, Tuscaloosa.